Georgia, presented by the Governor's Office of Highway Safety, reminding you to buckle up, Georgia, as we welcome you to Tom Ryden Stadium in Buford. It's the biggest regular season game of the year in the state of Georgia, as the number 3 Mill Creek Hawks have traveled across Gwinnett County to take on the number 1 ranked Buford Wolves. And good Friday evening. I'm Matt Stewart, joined by former Auburn Tigers All-American, NFL first-round draft pick, and 15-year pro Wayne Gandy. And Wayne, there's no other way to say it. This is a big game. Josh Lovelady, the coach from Mill Creek, admits it's probably the biggest game, regular season game, in their program history. Brian Appling, the Buford coach, says it's probably the biggest regular season game they've ever had at Tom Ryden Stadium. 8,000 sold out, standing room only, and we've got college coaches and NFL personnel observing the game tonight.
Such a big game that we're excited to call this game tonight. All the stars are out. I mean, it's like a premiere, movie premiere, stars all around, extra butter on the popcorn, Matt.
No doubt about it. Now, the story within the story is we have the top 2 prospects in the state, both committed to Alabama, playing head-to-head against each other tonight. Let's start with Mill Creek. They are 6-0, led by Caleb Downs, 5-star, number 1 ranked safety in the nation, number one ranked prospect in the state, and he will rarely come off the field tonight.
One of those guys you just run out of adjectives to describe. He's big. He's physical. He's their best offensive weapon. He is the best playmaker on defense. If there's something to be done for Mill Creek, Caleb Downs will be doing it.
His quarterback, Hayden Clark, is a 3-year starter, thrown for over 1,100 yards this season, 9 touchdowns, and 0 interceptions.
A great game manager, playing with tremendous confidence, throwing the ball around the field, scramble ability, dangerous with his feet. And the thing tonight, as you said, 0 interceptions against this Buford secondary is going to be key.
Defensive side of the ball, you have the son of Dirty Bird, Jamal Anderson, 4-star, number 9 right linebacker in the nation, committed to Clemson.
Big-time playmaker whose numbers, if you look at them, they are a little down. That's mainly because teams run away from him. He's going to have to come up big tonight against this physical O-line to stop the run game of Buford.
All right, the Buford Wolves, first season in 7A, 3-time defending state champions, 14 all-time state championships. They're led by the number 2 prospect in the state. That is 5-star running back Justice Haynes. He's the number 2 rated running back in the nation. He's the son of Veron Haynes of Hobnail boot fame.
Headed to Alabama, which lets you know the kind of running back he is. He has the speed to beat you anywhere on the field. He's making a splash for this team, 12 touchdowns, averaging 145 yards a game, and he's loving Buford, Georgia right now, and they're loving him.
And Justice Haynes isn't even the highest rated prospect for Buford. That would be this young man, KJ Bolden, 5-star junior, number 1 junior safety in the nation, number 1 junior prospect in the state of Georgia, and he has 50 offers.
The Caleb Downs for Buford, KJ Bolden, great athlete, long football instincts. He's there to make plays. They're going to need him offensively to stretch the field and keep this run game open for Justice Haynes.
And on the defensive side of the ball, another junior 5-star in Edrick Houston, the number 4 edge rusher in the junior class in the entire nation, and he has 40 offers.
Big, strong home wrecker, finds the quarterback. Some kind of way he gets there. He can make plays on the outside to the inside. A great pass rusher, and this defense only giving up 7.8 points a game. I mean, this is a clash of the Titans tonight.
It is stunning. There are 37 players on the field between these two teams who have college football scholarship offers. It is amazing. Now, speaking of amazing, our amazing star is John Nelson. He's standing by at Tom Ryden Stadium. Nelly?
Thank you, Matt. Thank you, Wayne. Good evening to all of you, however you are accessing us, large device or small. If you did not have a seat an hour before game time, you're standing for the duration. Matt, you said buckle up Georgia in the open. You were not kidding. There's a laundry list of coaches that are here, and you have foot traffic. You've got car traffic. And by the way, some coaches kind of have to do it through the air. out of the northeastern sky a little before 7 o'clock tonight. Kirby Smart from the University of Georgia. He made his way in. He circled around Tom Ryden Stadium, and he landed at the upper practice facility. He's here. He is not the only one who is here. Del McGee on his staff is here. Nick Saban is not here. You have representation from the University of Alabama. We've seen Ryan Day from Ohio State. We've seen Sean Elliott from Georgia. His whole staff is here. It is Mercer. It is West Georgia. It is 10 NFL teams represented, and these crazies are representing here because it's homecoming. So buckle up, Georgia. Hannah Gooden, what else is going on at 260-14th as we get ready for kickoff here at Tom Ryden?
John, it is loud there. Your ears are going to be ringing. I cannot wait to get that one started. But guys, our web game tonight should be a good one as well. It's a Region 2 5A matchup between Jones County and Dutchtown. The Greyhounds boast an offense that averages 41 points per win, while the Bulldogs have only allowed 49 total points over their 6 game this season. You can also watch it online, gbb.org/sports, or download the GPB Sports app. Don't forget to stick around after the game for the post-game show where John and I check in with coaches all around the state. I'll also see you guys at halftime. Take it away, Matt.
All right, thank you, Hannah. This is going to be a great ball game, and here's your chance to play along at home. Go to the QR code at the bottom of your screen, scan it, and pick the winner of tonight's game. So Buford at 6-0, Mill Creek at 6-0, both of them 1-0 in the region. No doubt the winner of this ball game will be the overwhelming favorite to be the region champion and a number one seed going into the state playoffs.
The top offense in 7A in Mill Creek averaging 46 points against the number two defense. It sets up to be a true battle of wills tonight between these two great teams.
All right, the opening kickoff is brought to you by Buckle Up Georgia. Buckle Up Georgia, seatbelts save lives. And Jacob Ulrich, who's one of the top special teams weapons in the state, ready to tee it up and kick it off for Mill Creek. And he lets it fly, and this kick is coming down at the 4-yard line. Return up across the 20 and up to the 30-yard line on the return for Buford, and that's where the Wolves will start on offense. Kobe Blackwell on the return for Buford. 26-yard return.
Big game, a lot of excitement early on. Who can handle that pressure, early pressure? But two programs that's used to that going deep into the playoffs and winning state championships.
Dylan Whitkey, the senior quarterback, a 3-star who's committed to Virginia Tech. 56% completion percentage, 540 yards, 6 touchdowns, and 5 interceptions. From the 32, right up the middle, Whitkey up to the 37, gets about 5 on the opening play.
Great job starting this game, getting the quarterback involved. Just a little read option here, right up the middle. Jamal Anderson there on the tackle. Dylan Whitkey, that's the kind of plays that he can make. He's athletic and dangerous running the ball.
Whitkey split time with 3-star Ashton Daniels, who's now a freshman at Stanford, now the uncontested number one quarterback. Toss goes to Justice Haynes, and Haynes will have the first down up across the 42 to the 43-yard line. As we take a look at the starting lineup for the Wolves on offense, it's brought to you by Regions Bank. Get back in the game with Regions Bank. Lubinga, the left tackle, is committed to LSU. McCammon, Chandler, Green, and Forrester, who has 4 offers. And then you've got Haynes, Williams, Bolden, White, and McElwainy, the backs and the receivers. 7-yard pickup for Justice Haynes on his first carry of the game. It's 1st and 10 from the 44. Play action. Whitkey going for the home run here near side. Jump ball for KJ Bolden, and it's going to be broken up. There is a flag down. That was Trajan Greco on the coverage. We'll check the penalty flag.
You imagine that this offense of Buford was going to early on try to get KJ Bolden down the field. Got to keep this defense honest. Right there, Trajan Greco just not getting his head around on this pass. Just a go route, letting KJ Bolden use his speed. Not a lot of contact, but as a cornerback, you got to turn and try to find the ball.
Defense. Defense. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot will result in a first down.
Patrick Ingram, our referee tonight, and the penalty announced against Mill Creek. So that'll be a first down for the Wolves across midfield.
Watch for Dylan Wickey and these receivers. Elijah Williams, Tyshawn White, Bolden, try to do something out on the edge, because you imagine this Mill Creek defense comes in to try to stop this run game. A lot of shifts and motions by Buford just to confuse you out of sets. They got to have a key instinct to find who's got the ball.
From the 41, pass is complete here on the near side. Pass completion to Jordan Allen, 14th catch of the season. He's been offered by Georgia Tech. That goes for 14 yards.
Nice job here by Allen. Just an out route, a lot of room. You can see Raging Greco, a lot of space for him to cover. Nice job of getting Allen down in that situation. These receivers can have a big night on the outside because they're going to get a lot of man-to-man coverage.
First and 10, ball is at the 27. Justice Haynes gets met in the hole. Just a couple of yards on the carry by Haynes as we take a look at the starters for Mill Creek on defense. Brought to you by Regions Bank. Maxey, Bothwell, and Denick up front. The linebackers are A.G. Anderson, Mullins, who's also a prospect, Anglin. And in the secondary, you go Greco, Patterson, Downs, and Content. Second down and 8, fifth play of the drive. Toss to Justice Haynes. He wants to throw it. Left-handed down the field. It's caught by McElwainy, the tight end, down to the 1 yard line.
Beautiful play here by the running back, Justice Haynes. Great job of leading McElwainy here on this pass. Put a lot of air under it. Running back pass right here all the way. But watch how he leads. Showing a little quarterback skill there. Not throwing the ball at him, leading him to the end zone, putting air. Nice ball, nice play design right there for Buford.
24-yard reception for McElwainy. First and goal to go for Buford. Quarterback keeper and Whitkey takes it in for the touchdown.
Great drive there. Nice drive by Dylan Whitkey. We saw him come out with a lot of poise. Throwing the ball in that drive. Mill Creek came in to stop the run. He's going to have to continue to make those kind of plays. Big drive to start this game by the home team.
There was a flag dropped on the play after the touchdown was scored. Might have a celebration penalty of some sort. Awaiting word from Patrick Ingram.
Following the play, unsportsmanlike conduct on the offense, a 15-yard penalty will be enforced on the subsequent kickoff. We've got one untimed down.
So the touchdown by Dylan Whitkey makes it 6-0, and the 15-yard penalty will be assessed on the ensuing kickoff. Mario Ventura is the kicker, Cole Taylor the holder, and Aiden Wilson is the long snapper, and we have another flag drop.
There's the flag.
Encroachment. Defense. Half the distance from the goal. Retry the untimed down.
So 15 yards rushing, 38 yards passing for Buford on that touchdown drive.
Very efficient drive. Offense.
Looks like they're going to go for two right here, and they get it. Snap went directly to Ryan McKinnis, who's a linebacker, and he takes it in for two and an 8-0 lead for Buford.
Taking advantage of the penalty, half the distance to the goal.
There's the score by McKinnis.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is presented by the Governor's Office of Highway Safety, reminding you to be safe on every trip. Buckle up, Georgia.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathe in your face, got me feeling some kind of way.
Of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
Half of the nation's opioid overdoses happen right at home because people don't understand the dangers of taking an Oxy or Perc with a glass of alcohol for stress or to sleep. Learn how to protect your family from opioid overdose at opioidresponse.info.
Welcome back to Tom Ryden Stadium. It is that time where we get to catch up with our friends at Buford and catch up with our friends from Cigna. The $1,500 donation from Cigna to Buford High School, hanging out with us, great friend of GPB, the AD here at Buford, Tony Wolf. Tony, thanks for being a great partner to Football Fridays this week in GPB and to Football Fridays all year long.
Thank you for joining us tonight. We are so proud of our football team, thankful for GPB and for Cigna and all you do for high school sports, and just really thankful for both communities, Mill Creek and Buford, for the great turnout tonight.
You aren't kidding, not 8,000 plus here. Once again, $1,500 donation to our friends from Buford, from our friends from Cigna, Matt Stewart. The rest of yours is here for the first quarter for 260-14th. Keep us going.
All right, thank you, Nelly. Ventura has it teed up and ready to kick off. Kicking off from the 25-yard line because of the 15-yard unsportsmanlike conduct that was assessed to Buford after the touchdown. So this is going to be returnable from the 20-yard line. And here comes Caleb Downs, and Downs across the 50 and out of bounds at the 41-yard line. 38-yard return by Caleb Downs, Wayne, the first time he touches the ball.
Pager's man with the ball in his hand. Confident, big, strong, and here showing you the athletic ability. A little showtime there, stiff arm at the end. He's ready for the game tonight in Caleb Downs.
And our first chance to see the Hawks on offense. And Caleb Downs, like we said, he's going to rarely come off the field tonight. He's going to be playing both ways and on special teams as Mill Creek takes over at the 42-yard line with their quarterback, Hayden Clark.
Downs in the backfield, a little trip set up top.
That's Cam Robinson, the running back, who sets now by the wide receiver. Gets the first handoff of the game. Cam Robinson down to the 39. Picks up about three on the play.
Nice job there by Edrick Houston getting off that tackle. He's going to be a handful all night long against his offensive line.
Look at the numbers for Clark, 55% completion. Also runs a 4.640, as you alluded to, Wayne. He will run the ball as well. He's dangerous with his legs. Second down and 7. That's Robinson in motion to the top of the screen. Pass is complete at the 33-yard line, and that'll be a first down for Mill Creek. Ball going to Brendan Jenkins. 11-yard pickup.
Nice find there by Clark to Jenkins there. A little motion out of the backfield to get some movement by Cam Robinson, drawing the defender up, finding just the little space, little stop route, yeah, making himself a big target for his quarterback is Jenkins.
Jenkins has 11 offers, back to action, ball goes complete out here to Mikael Wood. He's their top wide receiver, gets tackled by Damron at the 21-yard line. So we take a look at Mill Creek on offense, brought to you by Regions Bank. Get back in the game with Regions Bank. Murphy, Shine, Marshall, Banfield, who's a three-star, and Bothwell on the offensive line. The back and receivers, Robinson, Downs, Jenkins, Wood, and Mullins, the tight end. Second down and 3, line to gain is just inside the 19. Ball to the end zone and over the head. Wood the target. Third down and 3.
Mikael Wood had a step on the corner there, just not being able to find him down the field as Clark. A little rushed on that pass right there. Had the time, the protection was there to wait a second to get that ball. But you can see how this offense is high-powered, and why they have a lot of talent across the board in the receiving corps and a dangerous running back in Cam Robinson.
Clark has been offered by D2 Washburn and NAIA Reinhardt. Handoff goes to Cam Robinson, going to pick up the first down with a nice move in the hole. And down inside the 15-yard line goes Cam Robinson.
Montrez Walker, 14 for Buford. Not sure he knew that Cam Robinson had this ball right here. Didn't know whether to tackle him or not, but that's the count. Only listed at 180, 5'9", Cam Robinson, but he runs tough and physical between the tackles.
Averaging 119 yards per game with 9 touchdowns, they were unsure about their running back position coming into the season, thought it would be by committee. This former wide receiver stepped up and won the job.
Pleasant surprise for this offense, and has made himself a proud member of this team from the backfield. We knew what he could do in the slot, not on the edge, but now doing it from the running back position.
Caleb Downs makes a man miss, goes to the pylon, and touchdown, Mill Creek, but there is a flag down. You just see the pure athleticism. He's making guys who are also 4 and 5 stars missing the hole.
Matt, you took the words out. You could just see the difference in his approach to the game. He plays with so much confidence in his ability right there. Great vision on the cut. It looks like it's coming back on him.
Illegal shift. Offense. 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. Replay, first down.
Yeah, I tell you what, I mean, if you're Coach Josh Lovelady, you're tempted to give him the ball on every play. But he, you know, you don't have to give it to him on every play. Just the fact that he's on the field makes the defense worried that he's getting the ball on every play. Clark flushed out of the pocket, running inside the 10, steps out of bounds at the 7. And there's a good look at kind of his ability to get out there and make a play with his legs as we take a look at the Regions Bank starters for Buford on defense. Williams, Jeter, and Houston. Perlotti, who's a 5-star himself, Damron Banks and Walker. And then in the secondary, Blackwell White, who's a 4-star safety, Bolden the 5-star, and Williams the corner, who's been offered by Georgia Tech, Florida Atlantic, and Florida International. Just about everybody in the starting lineup has an offer somewhere. Second down. Clark can be wrestled down at the 9-yard line.
Great job there with Ryan McKinnis, number 8 for Buford, slicing through all that traffic. This is a quarterback draw all the way, trying to get to the outside. Decent blocking out on the edge there by Content, but making the big play right there. McKinnis, App State commit, getting off the block.
Yeah, McKinnis, 3-star linebacker, picked App over 12 other offers, including East Carolina. 3rd and 5. Clark, going to be tackled for a loss back at the 13-yard line, and a quarterback sack for the Wolves on defense. And Edrick Houston leading the way.
Big time pressure up front. 9 time roll right, get outside the pocket here. Looks like he's waiting for Caleb Downs, who is his big red zone target. A lot of green jerseys here you can see coming to the party. This defensive line, a lot of talent, hard to block in those situations. And Edrick Houston, he's the band leader up front for this defense.
I think it was Jack Damron who got to him first. This is a 29-yard attempt by Ulrich, who's 6-for-12 on the season. And the kick is blocked and kicked out of bounds by Mill Creek. And Buford will take over at the 20-yard line. ...29-yard field goal attempt blocked by the Buford Wolves. I believe that was 21 Devin Williams who got his hands on it.
Right here at the end.
No, it was right up the middle. It was McKinnis. Or 9, not McKinnis.
Elijah Williams right there to DN. Low kick. Not a lot of pressure by Williams, but able to extend and get a hand on that ball. What a big stand for this Buford defense. And that's how you're the top second-rated defense in the 7A division with those kind of plays. They had the short field, had some momentum, stopped Mill Creek when it counted.
9-play, 30-yard drive, and it stalls after the blocked field goal. Now, I thought they would take over at the 20.
Penalty. Got first down.
But they're putting it where Mill Creek kicked it out of bounds. So a penalty called here on the Wolves. Going to back them up another 5 yards. Maybe because the ball didn't get to the end zone.
Great time for this Mill Creek defense to step up and make a big play.
Short pickup right there. Justice Haynes, his third carry of the game.
Josh Anglin right there, 26, getting off the block. These linebackers are going to have a lot of pressure on them tonight. Not big up front. They're 3-4 base defense. And these linebackers are counting on to make those kind of plays. And Josh Anglin, their leading tackler right there, 26, able to get Haynes down.
Brian Appling, the only coach in state history to win state championships in his first three seasons, 47-3. Here now in his fourth season as the Wolves head coach, but his 20th season overall in the program. Justin Baker carries the ball that time, and he takes a big loss.
Big time play of Caleb Towns, and it just oozes on the screen. It oozes on the field here. Watch two come out of the secondary. He's not having any of this right here. Driving the legs, perfect tackling there. He's came, he's ready, he's engaged. As I said, Matt, in the open, just runs out of adjectives. The kind of player, you can see the difference. There's a difference into how his motion to other players on the field.
33 tackles, 4 PBU, 3 interceptions, adding to his program record 17 career picks.
Timeout, Buford. It's the first time out of the half.
Buford calls timeout while they think things over with 3rd and 12 coming up. We'll step aside.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Cigna. Together all the way. Cigna is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna's mission is to improve the health, well-being, and peace of mind of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being.
In lively towns and peaceful rural areas, Georgia's electric membership cooperatives are on a mission to provide a different kind of electricity. Our not-for-profit, member-owned EMCs are focused on making life better for members. At private residences, farms, and thriving businesses, we work for you. Generating safe, reliable, affordable electricity, giving back to local programs, serving our members to make life brighter. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
DVHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is about all Georgians standing together for substance abuse prevention. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
I can't believe how good they've been doing.
It's like their best season, I think.
I really want them to go to state this year, but I don't know if they can do it. Yeah, it's been a really close game.
Yeah, they need a big play.
Oh, dude!
Touchdown! They got it right back!
Yes!
Welcome back to Tom Ryden Stadium. 3.5 minutes to go here in the first quarter. 8-0 Buford with the lead. Let's get into our multi-screen experience tonight, and it is a battle of contrasting styles, but it has been the offense of Jones County that has been winning out so far. First quarter, 14-0, a touchdown, recover the onside kick, go down and score again. The Dutchtown Bulldogs in the key to battle, they've had a stout defense all season long. This big region battle, all first quarter, has been all Jones County, brought to us by our friends at Breda Pest Management, the official pest control of high school football. Matt Stewart.
Nelly, that's a little bit of a surprise there. Jones County's been up and down, and Dutchtown, top 5 in the state. So a little bit of an upset brewing right there with the Greyhounds against the Bulldogs. 3rd and 12 coming out of the timeout. Whitke stands in the pocket, delivers a strike at the 25-yard line, and a first down up to the 30-yard line, and a flag out after the catch by Jordan Allen goes for 20.
Great protection by the offensive line. Long developing play right there. Jordan Allen coming all the way across the field. Standing in the pocket is Dylan Whitkey. Look at his protection here. Great pocket to throw from. Snap on the ball to Allen. Big third and 12, and right there at the end, I think they're going to get Caleb Downs for a face mask or a horse collar right here.
I think, well, either one.
Either one in that situation.
I think they could flag it either one.
Horse collar tackle on the defense. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run. First down.
So a big 20-yard catch for Jordan Allen. His second reception of the game. Plus the 15-yard penalty. He's going to put the ball up at the 45-yard line. Four penalties now, 40 yards for the Hawks here in the first quarter. First and 10. Justice Haynes met right there. Going to be tackled and pushed back for a loss on the play by Langston Agee. As we take a look at the keys to the game, they are brought to you by Breda Pest Management, official pest control of high school football.
If you're Buford in this offense, you want to run the ball. Everything you want to do comes off the run with play action. And Mill Creek, can the defense find those alignments when this Buford offense starts to shift in motion? Make sure you align for gap integrity sake. You can't be caught off in the wrong gap against this kind of offense.
Second down and 12 after the TFL for Langston Agee, the 5'11", 180 senior linebacker. Toss goes to Justice Haynes. He tries to make a move and go to the other side, and he's going to be tackled at the 46-yard line. Nice pursuit by Justin Content for the tackle. Another flag down on the field.
Good penetration there by Mill Creek initially by this D-line. That's what they're going to have. You saw 25, Nick Derrick in the backfield there making Justice Haynes.
This one's going to go against the Wolves. So Josh Lovelady trying to figure out where the ball's going to be, what's the down going to be as to whether they want to take this penalty or not. He's in his fourth season, 32-11. 11-2 last year, got to the quarterfinals.
Offense, the penalty has been declined. It'll be third down.
You can see they're going to decline that, and now it's going to be more like third and 10, I think. So they were thinking third and 10 right here is better than second and 20.
The way that Dylan Whitkey is spinning the ball right here. You imagine your third down, you count on your defense to get some pressure and get off the field.
Would you have declined that or pushed him back?
I would have pushed him back.
Yeah, I think so too.
And put him in that second and extremely long. Yeah. Make them prove they can throw the ball down the field.
Yeah, third and nine's convertible.
Especially when you have a quarterback like Whitkey who can do it with his feet.
Let's see if this backfires on him, declining that penalty. Again, we have a whistle.
Timeout, Buford. Their second timeout of the half.
So Buford just burns their second timeout. First time these two teams have ever played against each other, even though, Wayne, the schools are separated by only 10 miles. That's because until this year, Buford had not been in 7A. But these kids grew up around each other, playing against each other, playing with each other in the Gwinnett Football League.
And you imagine this is such a big game for both of these teams at this point. So close, same community, a lot of friends, a lot of family in the same area. And this Mill Creek team has been hearing forever about the dominance of Buford.
Team Resume is brought to you by DBHDD. Win by learning about safe usage of prescription opioids. And Buford, the best team in the state, and they have been for 20, 25 years now. Three-time defending state champions. They've won 14 state championships, 10-plus wins in 23 straight seasons, 3-13-26 since 1999, 31 region championships, including last year as well. And the winner of this ball game will be the overwhelming favorite to win the Region 8 7A championship this year. This is the third long drive that we've had in this quarter. Second one by Buford. Facing third and nine, however, coming out of that timeout. with deep, guns it, and incomplete. Trying to go to K.J. Bolden for a second time in this game. And he's covered by Jaden Patterson, the safety. It's fourth down.
Pressure coming by Mill Creek, trying to get to Ricky. You can see good protection. Offensive line picks it up. And right there, just a bad ball right there by Dylan Wicke. Throwing the ball to the inside to his target there. K.J. Bolden, who was open if he had thrown it and led him to the outside. Big break there for Jaden Patterson in the Mill Creek secondary.
Long high punt by Cole Taylor, 40 yards and no return. That's even more important with Caleb Downs back there. And that's where Mill Creek will go on offense for the second time tonight. With 93 seconds left in the quarter, they drove down, had a field goal attempt blocked, actually had a touchdown taken off the board.
Working out on the edges in that first drive, trying to loosen up this defense, who has a top-notch secondary when you look at, especially at the safeties with Bolden and White, but you want to stay away from the middle of this defense and get the ball out quick because they have defensive pass rushers that will eat you alive.
First and 10 from the 15. Play action, quick pass incomplete. Went between two wide receivers over there. Kyle Pinckney and Brendan Jenkins were in the same proximity.
Aiden Perlotti right there almost coming up with a pick, breaking on the ball. Five-star outside linebacker, only a sophomore.
It's unbelievable.
It's just unbelievable. 6'4", 200 pounds. What a prospect and a big future he has.
He has 35 offers, including Tennessee, Ohio State, Florida State, Ryan Day, the Buckeyes head coach, supposed to be in attendance there tonight, among many others. Pass downfield, incomplete. Wide receiver goes down. Let's see if there's a flag on the play. Don't see one.
You see the Mill Creek coaches begging for a flag there. This is more of a coverage sack. Nowhere to go with this ball. Initially, no pressure in his face. As the play breaks down, just getting outside the pocket and getting rid of the ball before the sack gets there is Hayden Clark.
Clark 2 of 5, 18 yards. All of that came on the opening drive, the two completions, that is. Third down and 10. Drag route intercepted by Perlotti inside the 20-yard line. So Perlotti nearly had an interception a few moments ago. He gets the pick right there and puts Buford's offense in a great spot.
Only a three-man rush here by Buford, but coming off that edge, Elijah Williams right in the face there. And just can't throw this ball here. A lot of green jerseys in the middle of the field. Hayden Clark, first interception right there on the season for him. You can see number 9 coming off the edge with the pressure. Like he was trying to find Mikael Wood. Ball got away from him. Jaden Perlotti there coming up with the interception.
So the Wolves take over inside the 20-yard line, first and 10. Great opportunity for them to go up 2 scores right here. Going to go for it all right here. Whitkey fires for the end zone and broken up at the goal line by Greco, trying to go again to Jordan Allen. And the former basketball star Trajan Greco makes the play.
Nice break on the ball there. Staying back is Trajan Greco. Initially good protection, getting outside, kind of throwing away from his body and dangerous pass. You can see Greco and Downs in the area. This time, you see Greco getting his head back to spine the ball, breaking it up.
Greco's a guy that caught the attention of Will Muschamp when he camped at Georgia this summer. Second down and 10. Hand up right up the middle, down to the 12-yard line, Justice Haynes.
That's the thing about Haynes that you like. Not shying away from running between the tackles. He's known for his blazing speed. Yes, he has that. We'll get outside. You know, he has that kind of track speed in him. But he will lower those shoulder pads. And I think just pushing for 7-8 yards.
I saw him motioning to the sideline. He wants them to get up tempo here. 751 yards rushing. Right at 9 yards per carry, 10 rushing touchdowns, over 6,300 yards rushing in his career. Whitkey rolling to his right, has to get rid of it. And it's going to be fourth down. Looked like Whitkey went the wrong way, or Haynes, somebody went the wrong way on the play, it so appeared.
That's your son, 44 right here off the edge.
Or maybe it was just a bootleg. Of that.
Trying to get outside, bootleg, get the ball to Haynes out in the flat. You can see he's open, but big pressure there coming by the defensive end.
So this will be a 30-yard field goal attempt by Mario Ventura, the junior kicker. Kick is up and good, and an 11-0 lead for Buford. As the Wolves have now scored on their third possession of the game.
Have to tip your hat to this Mill Creek defense on that stance there. A lot of momentum for Buford to try to score a touchdown, go up early. They're able to plant their feet and stop them, hold them to a field goal, keep this game at a pace that they can get back in it, because right now their offense is not in full swing.
So really a good job by the Mill Creek defense after giving up that interception to Perlotte. They held him just 6 yards and forced him to settle for 3 points. So in that regard, a moral victory for Mill Creek's defense.
Especially early on in this game, Buford has everything going for him offensively, taking the first drive, touchdown, getting a big block on the field goal earlier in this quarter, and then coming up with Perlotte and the interception. This Mill Creek defense on that stand still keeping their team breathing in this game.
You saw the Governor's Red Ribbon campaign scoring drive for what it's worth, 4 plays and 6 yards. And Ventura will kick off. Jenkins standing deep. Oh, that might be Patterson. Had his jersey rolled up. Hard to tell whether that was a 12 or a 13. Pooch kick instead. Coming down at the 37-yard line and a 1-yard return. So good field position for Mill Creek as they get ready to go back on offense. Content with the return. 13 seconds left in the quarter.
And that's a function of trying to keep the ball out of the hands of Caleb Downs on the kickoff. Little pooch kick. Giving up big field position, yeah, though, for this offense. Starting at their own 40.
A little bit of a slow start here for Hayden Clark. 4 incompletions in the first quarter and an interception. So first and 10 from the 37-yard line. Ball is batted down and nearly intercepted. And that is number 47 for Buford, nearly coming up with the interception. John Frazier.
Nice job of reading the quarterback's eyes there by Frazier. Getting upfield. He sees the short setup, the quick setup by Clark. Not going to get there. Get my hands up. Knock the ball down.
Second down and 10. Handoff goes to Cam Robinson. And Robinson gets about 7 on the play on what was the final play of the first quarter. So we've played 12 minutes. At sold out Buford, Wolves on top 11-0 here after one quarter of play.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Regions Bank. Get back in the game with Regions Bank.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
Hey guys, it's time to reveal what I'm doing after graduation. We got my cupcakes and we got my schools. Let's just do it. Cupcakes aren't really my thing, and neither is going to a four-year college. Instead, I'm getting paid $18 an hour to train as a commercial plumber. There's a ton of other trades, like electrical and carpentry, where you can make great money, live a great lifestyle with little to no debt, and even be your own boss.
Cigna is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna's mission is to improve the health, well-being, and peace of mind of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being.
Start of the second quarter at Buford, the number one ranked Buford Wolves. They've won 17 in a row, lead Mill Creek 11-0. Matt Stewart, Wayne Gandy, John Nelson, Hannah Gooden. Wayne, let's take a look at your Breda Pest Management keys to the game.
This Mill Creek offense need to make in-game adjustments. Buford and their defense, like they're on a lot of schemes, they're going to have to continue to figure out what they're doing as the game goes on. And on defense for Buford, they just want to stop the run. They want to run the ball on offense. They want to stop the run, make the quarterback beat them. And so far, so good for that defensive front.
Beautiful in its simplicity. And they certainly have the talent to be able to do it. Third down and two as we start the second quarter. Robinson, 3 of 18, rushing the ball. He's going to get the handoff and going to get the first down, and Moore breaks out of there. Big run by Robinson, chased down from behind at the 35-yard line by McKinnis, the linebacker. 20-yard pickup.
Former wide receiver, moved to running back this year for his team. Met in the hole with the physical hit there. Big-time collision in the hole by Christian Butler, keeping his balance is Robinson, keeping those legs drive going right here. Big hit, able to stumble. You can see his offensive lineman there actually holding him up, keeping his balance, big third down conversion.
Yeah, Butler's 35 pounds heavier than Robinson, but he absorbs the contact and keeps on moving. Kevin Mitchell with his first carry of the ball game.
Got a little sense early on that was a big third down. They needed to be able to go out and get this offense and try to flip the field. You can't continue to give Buford these short fields. Nice job there.
Second down and 11. Clark going for the home run. Got a man out there. Wood catches it for the touchdown. Touchdown, Mill Creek, 46 yards, and the Hawks are on the board.
Big time night, big game, and big players shining. Mikael Wood here, just a go route out on the edge, man-to-man coverage on Devin Williams. Little roll out there by Clark, and here's just flat out talent. 6 feet, 160, senior. Three-star coming up with a big play for his offense and his team.
Ulrich on for the PAT. And it is going to be no good. Pushed it off to the right. So it's been a tough night for Ulrich so far.
Great job here. Play design. Forcing the one-on-one matchup. Mikael Wood, the leading receiver for Mill Creek this year. He is the go-to guy. You can see just a lot of field. That's a lot to ask of Devin Williams there. A lot of field for Woods to work in.
Mikael Wood, who is committed to Eastern Michigan, 10th career touchdown catch for that senior wide receiver. Chose Eastern Michigan over four other offers, including Georgia Southern, but he has been Hayden Clark's go-to guy this season.
And you imagine with him and Woods and Downs, you're going to get those kind of plays where you try to create those one-on-one matchup and take your chance with that 50-50 ball. Big-time season for that young man right there.
Here's a look at the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign scoring drive. 5 plays, 56 yards. 46 of it coming on the catch. Ulrich with the kickoff. And Haynes is standing deep, and he will not be able to return that. So they'll bring it out to the 20-yard line.
Both teams so far setting up the fight with their jab. Just get that feel there. As this game goes on, they're going to start throwing body blows right now. they seem to be on, some of that early energy has wore off, and they're playing football.
But you hit the nail on the head on that 3rd and 2 in the Cam Robinson 20-yard run to keep the drive going, resulted in that 46-yard touchdown.
Touchdown and giving their defense a break. Got a lot of guys on both teams going both ways, especially their star player and Caleb Downs. Got to find them times where he can catch a break.
So Dylan Whitke brings the offense back out. 2 of 5 passing, 34 yards so far in the game. And Justice Haynes gets about 4 yards on the play. He hasn't been a big factor in the game so far. That's just his 7th carry. He's right around 22 yards.
If you're Buford, it's a time where you might have to start feeding him back-to-back runs. Nice job by his future, at least right now, teammate Caleb Downs coming out that secondary to make that tackle.
How about those two guys going to Alabama?
Yeah, you know, that brings tears to my eyes. Yeah, there's a closer school. Hey, you don't have to.
Yeah, you're talking about Auburn. Yeah. You think about all the Georgia fans. You know, it brings tears to their eyes, too. The top two prospects in the state have both committed to play for Nick Saban and the Crimson Tide. A lot of people upset about that. Pass rush, ball out of there, complete at the 39-yard line. Harkness makes a cut back across the field and down to the 35-yard line. Great job by Whitke to get it out of there under pressure and find Sam Harkness for the 41-yard catch and run.
Standing in the pocket is Whitke to take the heat. You can see the pressure coming up the middle right in his face there. With the pressure is Josh Anglin getting the ball out. No one out there covering Harkness. Sometimes it's good to be the fourth receiver. Nobody pays you any attention. Coming up with a big play for the offense.
1st and 10 for the Wolves. Ball at the 35. They're back in business again. Justice Haynes patiently running down to the 20-yard line. There's no panic or anything in his run. He's just patiently running and waiting for it to open up.
Nice job showing patience, letting his offensive line get out in front, secure blocks here. As you can see, the guard and tackle pulling there. McCammon, Mubinga out on the edge, securing the blocks. And you're right, it's that cool, calm, almost like that Marcus Allen back in the day, Le'Veon Bell, where they just let the blocks and then hit you with that exploding speed.
15-yard pickup for Justice Haynes, 8 carries. 37 yards for him tonight. Right up the middle, Christian Butler, his first carry of the ball game. We first saw Christian Butler last year against Tequila, and we were like, who is this guy?
6'3", 215, big, physical. There's no mistake what he comes in the game to do. He comes to punish the defense, lowering those shoulders and just drive for 5 yards.
He's been offered by Florida Atlantic, Tennessee Tech, and Grambling State.
Right now, putting a successful answer. Drive is Buford right now, answering Mill Creek.
2nd down and 5. And movement on the Wolves.
A lot of shifts and motions there. You can see by that Buford offense.
Ball start. Offense. 5-yard penalty. 2nd down.
That was the fullback, Elijah Williams. Yes, I said that right. Fullback. They still have fullbacks, at least in high school they do.
At least in Buford, Georgia they do. Yeah, that's what they like to do.
Yeah, we don't see them much in high school anywhere, except Buford.
Multiple looks, and for defenses now, seeing a fullback, they're confused. They have no idea what that position is.
2nd down and 10. Whitke fires, caught. McElwainy, touchdown. 2nd big catch for the tight end, Eli McElwainy tonight. Goes for 22 yards.
Beautiful execution by the offensive line. Big pickup here. Coming off the edge is pressure for Mill Creek. Number 9, Elijah Williams picking up the rusher. You can see at the top of your screen right there, picking up Jamal Anderson and just wide open, busted coverage on the back end to McElwainy for the touchdown. What an answer by the Wolves offense. Big time game.
And they look good. four of the first six opponents they've played have been ranked in the top 10. This makes seven, five out of seven playing Mill Creek here tonight. They are battle tested and they've got the wins and the pelts on their belt. Touchdown pass to McElwainy, 18-6, Buford on top.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign. Celebrate life, live drug-free. DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is about all Georgians standing together for substance abuse prevention. Celebrate life, live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
Hi, I'm Tommy Sharp with You Save It Pharmacy, and I'm proud to present to you this week's You Save It Pharmacy Student Athlete of the Week.
Well, he's been blessed with a lot of talent.
It's really a blessing being the third overall player in the state.
Growing up in a coaching family that he's learned some of the lessons that we hope to teach.
Really not trying to let things get to my head and really just trying to be a normal person.
I hope you've enjoyed watching the You Save It's Pharmacy Student Athlete of the Week. If you'd like to watch our full interview, please follow this link.
Welcome back to Tom Ryden Stadium, 7:52 to go first half, 18-6 the lead for the Buford Wolves. Let's get you into our second screen experience tonight. It has been an early start for Jones County. Jones County with two scores on the board. They led 14-0. Dutchtown has responded with a touchdown, so the margin has closed with that big defense of Nikita Battle and the Bulldogs still trailing right now to Jones County. That one is second quarter in the Southern Crescent. You can watch that one at gpb.org all night long. Brought to us by our friends at Breda Pest Management, the official pest control of high school football. Touring the state, big region battles going on right now. Coffee with a lead at the half, 21-3. Roswell leading Pope, no surprise, in 6A, 28-3. Brooks County in a non-region game leading 7-0 second quarter. Also, Rabun and Elbert, Rabun leading 14-0. Colquitt County leading 21-7. Back to 260, 14th, and Matt Stewart.
Eli McElwainy, two catches for 46 yards tonight. He had one catch for 12 yards in the first six games of the season. Content with the fair catch on the pooch kick. But that is just an example of how Buford can beat you. They've got so many different weapons. They can bring a tight end out who hasn't been used hardly at all this season and make him a weapon tonight.
Very deep at each position. And this offense right now is humming. He came in expecting them to run so far in this first half. That four plays over 20 yards. McElwainy, they're wide open, busted coverage. Nobody's in the screen with him. Big-time player, big-time program.
I mean, when you have one catch, they're not expecting McElwainy to get the ball. He's had two big catches, one down to the one-yard line, and then a 22-yard touchdown catch just a few moments ago. So Mill Creek back on offense. They're in trouble. They're down 12 points. And Cam Robinson showing a lot of fortitude, squirms forward, gets close to five on the play.
Not sure what they were going to do from that running back position when the season started. Can't press upon you enough, Cam Robinson. It's one thing to play slot, and you're in a lot of traffic. But for a guy like him to switch over and start running between the tackles, take those hits, an outstanding job.
He's had a big season. There's no doubt about that. Now an empty backfield for the Hawks. Gotta find a way to get Caleb Downs more involved in the offense, don't they? Second down and five. They're going for the home run, and Jenkins can't come up with it. Kobe Blackwell great coverage over on Brendan Jenkins here on the near sideline.
Once again, the four-man stack at the top of the screen, empty backfield, trying to create that one-on-one matchup, take the big shot down the field. Jenkins on Blackwell, this time Blackwell able to tight coverage, can't come up with the catch. And I can see right now Mill Creek is going to continue to test these corners in those one-on-one situations.
You got to get the first down here. You can't give Buford the ball back, right? Third down and five. Quick pass high. Trying to go to Wood. You had Caleb Downs out there blocking for him. Misfire by Hayden Clark, and they're going to have to punt it away.
Look, wide receiver screen, trying to get the ball behind that stack with Downs blocking out in front of him. A little high on the throw there by Clark. Right now, having to punt this ball back to Buford. It's just a dangerous time in this game for Mill Creek.
So Ulrich on to punt. Jordan Allen standing deep for the Wolves. Ulrich is averaging 42 yards per punt this season. Going to take it from the 18-yard line. Jordan Allen, in the open field. Got the punter to beat. Got a blocker. He's going to go the distance. Touchdown, Jordan Allen and Buford.
We talked about Mill Creek having to punt this ball, that they're in a little danger zone. Didn't know it was going to happen this quick, but we have these kind of athletes out on the field. Just talent. Only a sophomore. Jordan Allen with that track speed out in the open field. Big block there by his DN. Edric Houston, some kind of way, finds his way into the blocking scheme and a big touchdown to put more pressure on Mill Creek in this first half.
24-6. .42-yard punt, .82-yard punt return. Took it at the 18 and took it to the house. And the PAT is good in a 25-6 lead for Buford.
Nice job here by Allen. Right here just felt like when he got into the open field, only the punter to beat, a blocker in front.
And a five-star
holding, which is a great job by Houston, not holding.
I like his chances. He gets out there. He's got a five-star defensive end blocking for him against the punter. When I saw that, it's done. It's a done deal right there.
And now can this Mill Creek offense find some kind of way against this defense and the mounting pressure against a team like Buford that any moment can go on one of those eight-minute drives with their run game?
82-yard punt return. Sophomore who's already been offered by Georgia Tech. Yellow Jackets coaching staff there tonight watching this game.
Back to receive for the Hawks.
They just shuttle them in and shuttle them out, don't they? They just got so much talent. Nothing about that play said sophomore. Right there, a big-time player, big-time play by Jordan Allen.
Buford ranked number 7 in the nation in the USA Today top 25. Mill Creek checked in at number 21, and that kick is going to bounce out of bounds. Would let it go, and they're going to bring it out to the 35. That's why I was saying a few moments ago when Mill Creek was on offense facing that 3rd and 5, they got to get the first down. You can't give them the ball back.
You can't give this offense the ball back.
Or the special teams.
Free kick out of bounds. On the kicking team, we'll re-kick following a 5-yard penalty.
So they're going to make them re-kick, which is an option, rather than take it at the 35.
The re-kick also sometimes has been used by coaches from a fatigue factor. Your coverage team has ran all the way down there. Now you're hoping maybe to catch them breathing a little hard, get a little curve, get a little corner, and be able to get a big return for yourself.
Another pooch kick. This one's coming down at the 33, caught by Content. And so that's where Mill Creek is going to go on offense. Let's take a look at the Hawks resume brought to you by DBHDD. Made the playoffs 8 straight years, quarterfinals in 2019, 2021, semifinals in 2015 and 2016. They were 13-1 in both of those seasons, best seasons ever. They've won 2 region championships. They did it in 15 and in 16. Josh Lovelady, who was an assistant on Shannon Jarvis's staff. Jarvis, the head coach of the program for the first 15 years, and now he's at Elbert County with the top 10 team. 46 points per game for Mill Creek. They've been held to 1 touchdown so far here tonight. Ball is fumbled. Let's see if Buford's on top of it. The Wolves are indicating they've got it. Nothing from the officials just yet. And they've got it. My goodness, Mill Creek just coughed it up on the first play after surrendering that 82-yard punt return.
There's a flag on the field. Not sure if it's a legal procedure penalty by Mill Creek or offside by Buford.
Illegal shift on the offense. The penalty will be declined. Ball's turned over on the fumble on that. Please reset the game clock to 6 minutes.
Robinson never got it. A little bit high on the handoff. Hit off his shoulder pads, the front of his shoulder pads, rather getting the handoff right in the gut like you want it. Second takeaway for the Buford defense tonight. So first and 10, Wolves go back on offense. Let's see if they take a shot at the end zone here. Nothing doing right there. Lost some yardage on that play. Trying to run a reverse. Tyshawn White, first touch for him on offense tonight.
Interesting call in that situation. Typically, you want to go to your best player. In this case, Justice Haynes here. And with a reverse, not fooled at all by the defense right there. Nice job by them staying home. Nick Maxey, defensive end, coming upfield, staying home. Tyshawn White for the negative play.
Second and 17. Wittke in the pocket, scrambles around, buying time, looking downfield. Now going to be sacked back at the 49-yard line. Josh Anglin, the linebacker, with the quarterback sack. Back-to-back big plays by the Mill Creek defense.
Just all hustle here by Josh Anglin here on this play. Pressure on the outside by Anderson. Their leading tackler there in Anglin, 26. Just keep working to the ball. Right now, they're winning on these set of downs against this offense.
Josh Lovelady says Josh Anglin reminds him of Rennie Curran. He went on to start at the University of Georgia. Lovelady coached Curran when he was on the South Gwinnett staff. T. McFerrin, big run, getting a lot of it back right there. Justin Baker all the way down to the 27-yard line. On third and 27, he picked up 20.
Just going with the safe draw in this situation. There's no third and 26 play. Here, just going with the delayed draw. And this is just all about athletics and effort, running and pounding down the field. Nice job by Baker, also a sophomore. Now sets them up for fourth and short. Can you imagine if Buford will take their time and try to pick this up?
Look at that. 9 offers for the sophomore running back, including Southern Cal, Penn State, and Arkansas.
Looks like it may have been a penalty. Are they bringing the ball back?
Yeah, it looks like it.
Offense, 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Replay third down.
So erases that big run by Justin Baker. So now third down, let's figure out the yardage. They got a long way to go. Third and 35.
Third and 35. Typically, you run the same kind of draw or screen out on the edge, something. Try to get in one of your best players' hand, maybe make a big play. I'm going to take a chance and then throw an interception here.
Whitkey, complete out on the edge to White. Tyshawn White dropped at the 44-yard line. Going to be well short of the first down.
Good job of getting the ball and getting upfield, a four-star safety. Out on the edge, one of those players when you come to Buford, regardless of your star, you're going to end up in that two-way go situation for this team.
Cole Taylor on to punt for the first time. Boots it away from the 45. Coming down, fair catch. Called for, goes over the head, and they did not save it from going into the end zone. That's a 44-yard kick, and they'll bring it out to the 20-yard line. Under four to play in the half. Buford leading 25-6.
While we've got a quick break in the action, did you know that the same area of just one football field can contain up to 95 termite colonies? That's why you need Breda Pest Management to defend your home. Breda, the official pest control of high school football.
When you work on your own terms, every day feels like Friday. That's why at Friday Health Plans, we provide health insurance for professionals who do just that. Independents, freedom seekers, those who follow their own career path, even if it doesn't come with a company health plan. Open enrollment for 2023 health insurance starts November 1st. Friday Health Plans, for people who buy their own health insurance.
Let me know if I can help you with anything.
Just looking. I only buy local and sustainable, so.
Oh, well, that shirt's not local. You should be wearing cotton. Georgia's a major supplier of cotton worldwide, so if you'd like to buy local to support Georgia, buying cotton's a great place to start. It's renewable and sustainable, naturally.
Thanks.
And that's a polyester fiber made of oil.
By the way, where's your dressing room?
Welcome back to Tom Brydon Stadium. Buford leading Mill Creek 25-3 coming up in just a few minutes on the region's halftime show. We will take a look at other top battles happening all around the state. Here's an update for you in Region 1-7A. It's an opener for 6-0 Colquitt County. Packers are beating Camden County 28-7 in the second. In our web game, gbb.org/sports or on the GBB Sports app. That's a Region 2-5A battle. Jones County leading 6-0. Dutchtown 14-7 in the second. That's a surprise. A lot more of where that came from in just a few minutes, Matt.
Thank you, Hannah. 25-6. You see Kirby Smart on the sideline with the Alabama coaching staff. Of course, he used to be a coach on that Alabama coaching staff.
I think they're talking about a game in December that's building up. Yeah.
The one they usually play at MBS. Yep. Pass incomplete, trying to get the ball to Jenkins. And all kinds of coaches. You heard John Nelson tell you before we started the game. Of course, Kirby Smart, two members of the Alabama coaching staff. Of course, they've got a big game tomorrow at Tennessee, so Nick Saban not here, but he sent his emissaries to check on his top two prospects out of the state of Georgia, Caleb Downs and Justice Haynes. And they played really supporting roles here tonight. They haven't been the big story. They've been part of the big story. Just so many weapons, like you said to me just a few moments ago. Almost anybody on this Buford team can make a big play, offensively or defensively. Pass is complete. That's Jamal Anderson, his first catch of the game. Shoved out of bounds at the 40-yard line.
Nice route there by Jamal Anderson. Coach Lovelady talked about his ability, especially out in space. Because this is how your five-star or four-star linebacker should be out in space catching the ball. What an athlete he is, long and lengthy. In those kind of situations, that's where you want to get him the ball. Those one-on-one matchups out on the edge, he's that spread tight end for this team.
Caleb Downs on the run. First down for Caleb Downs. across midfield and down to the 35-yard line. So you see Mill Creek kind of getting into a desperate situation here, going back-to-back to Jamal Anderson and then Caleb Downs.
Very surprised. Those guys will get more touches this time coming out of the backfield. Showing you skills where you think he's really a running back. That's the thing about when they flip over, they look like that's their natural position.
And a quarterback sack back at the 43-yard line as Hayden Clark could not get rid of the ball and sacked by Ryan McKinnis.
Nice job by McKinnis again. Not really sure right there. Yeah. Clark looked like he had froze right there, like deer in headlights. After he faked the RPO, didn't know where he wanted to go with the ball. Nice tackle there by McKinnis.
Another big pickup for Appalachian State here in the state of Georgia. They do a good job of recruiting the state. Clark being chased, going to slide down at the 38.
Pressure once again. Houston and Williams up front off the edge. That's the thing about you look in their numbers, not a lot of sacks for this defense, but just always harassing the quarterback. Quarterbacks never feel comfortable just sitting at that spot. And they do a lot of that with just a three-man rush up front.
Third down and 12. Timeout called by Buford. That'll be the last for them this half.
It's their final timeout of the half.
You know, you can't look at the Buford stats and measure their performances because the stats, they don't have any players whose stats jump off the page at you because they use so many different players. They are so deep. Nobody's got spectacular stats, but they're all spectacular players.
Definitely. They get out on the field. They rotate. They have an unselfish culture, I think, is what stands out the most. That don't worry about how many carries. Don't worry about how many snaps. When you do get in the game, there's a standard that you have to live up to.
Buford trying to do something that no one's ever done, and that's win a state championship in every classification. You see, just 20 years ago, they were still in single A, little country school, but they have grown as the city of Atlanta has grown. Six titles in double A. Two in AAA, one in 4A, one in 5A. The last two have come in 6A. Now they're playing in 7A.
Seems like each level just goes and take a vote. Like, look, you got to go. That's enough of that.
Exactly.
You need to go find somebody else to play. And they have done an excellent job. If you never tuned into Buford, you would have already thought they were at a 7A level with the kind of talent they put out on the field.
Third down and 12 coming up here. And my question at the start of the season wasn't, can they win the 7A state championship? My question is, who's going to stop them from doing it? Third and 12, they're running the screen pass. Goes to Caleb Downs. Downs has the first down and more.
Big time player. I mean, right now, having to do it on both sides of the ball. Showing a little power there at the end of this run here. Just a little comeback and then let the athlete go to work. Look at the speed, the explosion. And as I said a couple of plays ago, they look like that's their natural position. He's a big-time safety that looks like a dominant running back.
Pass completion to Jamal Anderson. Things getting a little chippy out there after the catch by Anderson, his second one on this drive. And now flags come out. Yeah, Jamal Anderson might be the guy who gets the unsportsmanlike penalty as you see frustration starting to kick in.
Anderson and Bolden right there snapping at each other, probably just arguing over how many stars they have in the field. I mean, it's so much talent. You expect that kind of moxie when you have those kind of players. You got to control it because right now Mill Creek, they do not need penalties like this by Jamal Anderson.
And I know you can't beat a team by using Caleb Downs and Jamal Anderson, giving them the ball on every play, but that might be the only way Mill Creek can beat Buford is for those guys to get, you know, 90% of the touches from here on out.
Sportsmanlike conduct, defense, half the distance to the goal, results, first down.
Well, good for Mill Creek there. Typically, the person who says something last is the one who gets caught. And this time they threw the flag on Buford, not Mill Creek. So first and goal to go. Huge possession for Mill Creek to have a shot at winning this game in the second half. They've got to get six right here.
And the usage of Anderson and Downs on this drive, as you talked about, is you're down 19 points. You got to figure out a way to get back in this game, even at cost on you on the other side of the ball.
Handoff goes to Downs, and he's going to take it in for the score. Caleb Downs, 6-yard touchdown run. And there's your evidence right there. Mill Creek's path to victory, coming back and being in this game, is going to be how many times can they give Caleb Downs the ball? How many times can they get the ball to Jamal Anderson?
Nice blocking in front of him by Cam Robinson, offensive line. Great zone blocking up front. Almost a walk-in.
Timeout. Mill Creek. It's our first time out of the half.
Yeah, I think they're trying to figure out, you know, what kind of two-point play are we going to run here. They've got to do that. Ninth rushing touchdown of the season for Caleb Downs. Caps an 8-play, 80-yard drive. Gets him back in the game. He's special.
Zone blocking up front. Nice job by the line. You see his Cam Robinson. Little kick out blocked by him. And then just the power running game, as I said.
Wayne, is it just me? But I'm watching this play, and I'm revisiting memories of Eric Dickerson right now.
Definitely the size. Has that body position.
Yeah.
He does look like.
Looks like Eric Dickerson. My goodness. And you're right. I mean, you hit the nail on the head. I mean, he's the number one safety in the country. You're watching this game, and you'd think, well, maybe he's the number one running back in the country. He could be whatever he wants.
Definitely has those kind of skills. And I know headed to Tuscaloosa with the Tide, they're a big defensive team. But there's sparks that he shows with the ball in his hands that definitely makes you feel like maybe I should switch him to the other side of the ball.
Yeah, they were camping at Georgia this summer. And Josh Lovelady tells the story sitting there talking to Kirby Smart. And Caleb Downs is throwing balls 40 yards downfield. And Kirby was like, you got to be kidding me. What does this guy not do? Going for two right here. Clark whips it out there. Complete the wood. And there's the two-point conversion to make it 25-14.
Great play design here by Mill Creek in his offense. Kel Wood, you can see him coming in motion. The stop, wide receiver screen out on the edge. Coming in motion out on the edge. A little fake there by Clark. You'll take that matchup anytime in that situation. These players are coming alive, and I think that Mill Creek understands that any chance their star players have now have to take over this game.
Speaking of their star players, here's a look at Mill Creek's top prospects. Caleb Downs, the 5-star, committed to Alabama. Jamal Anderson, the 4-star linebacker, committed to Clemson. Mikael Wood, 3-star wide receiver, committed to Eastern Michigan. Aiden Banfield, a 3-star guard, who has 5 offers, including Georgia Tech and Vanderbilt. And Cole Mullins, who's also a baseball prospect, doesn't have any stars yet, but he's been offered by Wake Forest and Duke. And just this week, Vanderbilt gave him an offer. So Mill Creek back in the game, and if you're a Hawks fan, you're thinking, well, we still have a chance after what you saw from Caleb Downs and Jamal Anderson on that previous drive. Ball coming down at the 1, and it's fumbled and picked up, and it's going to work out well for the Hawks, and the Wolves barely get back to the 10-yard line. So strategically placed kickoff, and there is a flag down as well. And they trap him down deep after a short return by Traylon Maddox. Let's check the penalty flag.
During the return, illegal block in the back on the return team. Half the distance to the goal from the spot of the foul. First down, Buford.
So Mill Creek, I think, has 2 timeouts remaining here. We'll see how they use them. See if they can try to get the ball back.
Nice time for this defense to stand up, get some pressure. maybe a turnover, try to get the offense a short field right here before half.
Ball is going to be placed down at the 2-yard line. First and 10. Tackle right there at the line of scrimmage. Big time play by Justin Content.
Physical corner, former safety, looking like it right there. He's a cornerback now. You can see his ability to step up in the hole. Haynes right there trying to get to the outside. And when you look at it from the wide view, not sure if that tackle's not a touchdown saving tackle. We know the kind of foot speed that Haynes has. Nice tackle there by Content.
Content, also a swimming star for Mill Creek. Second player that we've seen this year that have the swimming and football combo. Must be something new because that never used to happen, but he's a great athlete in the pool and on the football field as well. Man down for Buford. We haven't been able to ID him just yet.
Looks like maybe Mbinga. I'd say that's 65.
Yep.
Yeah. I could tell by how the hands are taped. It looks like.
What a player.
Take them thumbs up, that hands up if you're playing those tackle positions.
What a player Mbinga is. Only been playing football for 3 years. Now he's committed to LSU. Chose the Tigers over 41 other offers, including Michigan, Texas A&M, North Carolina. Hopefully he's okay. Rated as a guard by ESPN, top 25 in the nation, 6'4", 280. And Coach Brian Appling says reminds him a lot of former Buford Wolves great, who also went on to play at LSU, Vidal Alexander.
All the intangibles, great feet by Mbinga, 6'4", 280. Right now, next level, LSU, there's still another 15, 20 pounds to put on at the next level.
Hopefully he's going to be okay as they assist him off the field. That would be a big loss for this Buford team. The backup on the depth chart at left tackle is Vincent Forney, who's the son of Keenan Forney.
Old teammate of mine, Keenan Forney, with the Falcons for 2 years. And he has a big job right now, stepping in early in this game. We're still in the first half, so Forney is going to have to step up quickly.
Let's see if they bring him in, 71, or they slide somebody, but he's the next guy on the depth chart. Second down and 10. Whitkey going to pass out of the end zone and incomplete at the 43. Third time they've tried to go to K.J. Bolden without success. Jaden Patterson, who was a corner, moved to safety on the coverage.
Running step for step with Bolden. Had a chance. Whitkey throwing out of his own end zone here. Yeah, early on had a step there on Patterson. Just not able to come up with the catch is Bolden.
Whitkey is 5 of 9 passing for 113 yards. Bolden has not yet had a big impact on this game offensively. Third down and 10. This is a big play. They can get the ball back if they get the stop. I mean, out of the end zone. Justice Haynes will not get the first down. So Mill Creek going to stop the clock with another timeout and force Buford to punt out of their own end zone.
Mill Creek.
Nice job. Nice job of rallying to the ball by that defense. You could see Haynes just about to squeeze up out of there. You know how dangerous he is when he gets to a foot race. Nice job of the defense, not counting on one man to bring a player of his caliber down. See here, about to squeeze out of that gap, about to start running. Nice job getting off the block there. Luke Mintz, 21.
Chad Hodges, Jeff Zemiskowski, the co-defensive coordinators for this Mill Creek program. They've done a pretty good job. I mean, Buford's hit them with a couple of big plays, one on special teams. But they've come up with some big stops, and that was maybe the biggest of the game because Mill Creek's going to get the ball back and still have one timeout remaining and a chance to score again. And remember, you got Ulrich, who has hit a 56-yard field goal in a game this season.
If you're Buford, you can't fall asleep when you have a return man like Caleb Downs, who's probably going to be back in this situation. You're going to come with the pressure here, forcing the punter to get the ball off quick, or do you play back and just let your return man set up the blocks?
Fourth and three, and they're going to run a fake and pick up the first down. Justice Haynes across the 30 and still on his feet all the way up to the 42-yard line. How about that gutsy call? Inside your own 10, you run a fake punt and pick up the first down with a 33-yard run.
Coach App, I got to call you for the lottery numbers on this play right here. Great job by the punter faking it and then get it to your best offensive weapon out on the edge. Just won't go down as Haynes picking up a big fourth down punt. I mean, wow, that is a big play there.
That's unbelievable that they would do that. Ice water in your veins. Flags out as they go to Bolden. First catch for him. He gets slung out of bounds by Patterson. Let's check the penalty call. But my goodness, the guts that it takes to run that play if you fail. Can you imagine? Illegal
shift. And I think that's just coach recognizing the magnitude.
Yeah.
I do not want to give this team this ball back on this short field punting team.
Illegal shift on the offense. 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. We'll replay first down.
I need to find a way to get into the half with the score 25-14 and keep that momentum.
Yeah. No doubt. I mean, he saw exactly how big that was, and he saw and remembered exactly how Mill Creek was able to score on their previous possession. He realizes this game is far from over. So first and 15 following the penalty mark-off. Pocket stands up for Witke. Now it breaks down. He fires and nearly intercepted at the 50-yard line.
Great job.
Content nearly had himself a pickoff and should have. John, what you got?
When you look at Coach App, a fake punt on a fourth down, you learn something like that from a predecessor like Jess Simpson. Jess Simpson, he learned from him, don't be afraid to take chances. You want to talk about a chance, that's taking a chance. Leave no stone unturned on a game plan. You see stuff like that come out in film, you end up with a successful fake punt deep in your own end, Matt.
Yeah, it's crazy. Ball goes to Haynes, and Haynes out across the 50 to the 48. They'll keep moving here. There's still time on the clock. 15-yard pickup. Stop clock for the chains to move. They hustle back to the line. Clock moving again. And they'll spike it. This gives them an opportunity to take a shot at the end zone.
Second down. Try to get the ball out. Player, when you got a player like K.J. Bolden and Elijah Williams, tall receivers, and you got a field goal kicker, you just think, hey, maybe I can get another 20-yard chunk play down the field.
Well, this is great job by, you know, both these teams. Mill Creek had the same thought process in mind. Squeeze every second out of this half. Don't miss a scoring opportunity. So 11 seconds left in the half. Ball at the 47. Pressure's coming. Witke chased out of there. Going to run to the sideline and get out of bounds with under 5 seconds left, 4 seconds left in the half.
Pressure right in his face in the middle of the offensive line. Nice job of Wicky, as we talked about. Athletic scrambler that can get out on the edge here, making the best decision. Just get out of bounds. still leave yourself enough time to run a play, a Hail Mary to the end zone.
That's what they'll try to do right here if they give him protection. Whitkey having to move around, throwing downfield, might have been across the line of scrimmage, jump ball goes incomplete, and that's the end of the half. And Jamal Anderson, the 6'4 linebacker, was back there in the end zone to make sure that that pass gets batted down.
Anderson and Downs.
Solid half for Dylan Whitkey and a 25-14 lead for Buford. John Nelson is standing by with Coach Brian Applin.
You know, Coach, when we were talking this week and you talked about what you learned from your predecessors with Jess Simpson, it was leave no stone unturned, don't be afraid to take chances. You certainly did that with that fake punt inside your own 10.
I just felt like they had a lot of momentum and we needed to recapture something, just not give up any more points for halftime so we can get back in and make adjustments.
So then what did you think of that first, say, 15, 16 minutes when you had the big lead on the board?
I mean, I thought we were playing really well. I mean, we hadn't done anything different since that point. We got a turnover we didn't capitalize on, and just, you know, we gave up a long drive right there. So, I mean, we're playing pretty good. We just got to keep it going and come out with some more energy at the halftime.
All right, we'll keep an eye on the third quarter.
Appreciate it.
Brian Appling, the head coach of Buford, had a big lead. Mill Creek came back to score, but the big fake punt kept him from getting any more points on the board. Let's send it to 260-14th and Hannah Gooden, because the halftime show starts right now.
Thanks, John. What a half and great coaching by Coach Ab. Coming up on the Region Halftime Show, we'll hear from Buford running back Justice Haynes on why he committed to Alabama over Georgia and others. We'll update you on top games happening around the state. Take a look at our play of the first half. Name our TikTok challenge winner. It's all next right here on GPB Sports.
To participating Georgia Electric Membership Cooperatives, congratulate each and every school on winning the GHSA Cooperative Spirit Sportsmanship Award. This award honors schools that exhibit exemplary sportsmanship during competitive events. Georgia's EMCs and the 32 participating membership cooperatives are proud to sponsor the Cooperative Spirit Sportsmanship Award. Congratulations to all the winners in 2022.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by DBHDD. Win by learning about safe usage of prescription opioids.
Half of the nation's opioid overdoses happen right at home because people don't understand the dangers of taking an Oxy or Perc with a glass of alcohol for stress or to sleep. Learn how to protect your family from opioid overdose at opioidresponse.info.
The Georgia Department of Community Affairs and the Georgia Rental Assistance Program, currently helping Georgians with rent, utilities, and other housing expenses. They will pay the landlord or utility provider directly for these expenses even after an eviction. If you, a friend, or family member knows someone who could use this assistance, paymyrent.ga.gov provides program details and explains how to apply for relief. paymyrent.ga.gov can help. Help is here.
Today's conservation-minded consumer cares about where their energy comes from. Your local EMC cares, too. Georgia's Electric Membership Cooperatives offer renewable options for our members. In fact, our solar portfolio will produce enough clean energy to power more than 180,000 households, striving to move the needle toward progress and position communities for the future. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
Hey everyone, welcome to the Football Fridays in Georgia halftime show presented by Regions. Get back in the game with Regions Bank. I'm Hannah Gooden. We are live from the GPB Sports Studios in Atlanta. It's halftime of Mill Creek versus Buford. Even though these schools are only 9.5 miles apart, this is their very first meeting and Hawks head coach Josh Lovelady's first ever visit to Tom Ryden Stadium. Both teams boast elite level talent with a combined 37 players who have been offered football scholarships. Two of those are good friends we've been watching tonight going head-to-head. That's Mill Creek safety Caleb Downs and Buford running back Justice Haynes. The seniors will be heading to Tuscaloosa next year to play for the University of Alabama together. I caught up with Haynes, who is definitely ready for the next level, as we can see. Here's why he chose the Tide over Georgia and others.
Just the development piece. I knew Coach Saban was going to develop me on and off the field. I knew he was going to hold me accountable. I knew he was going to make me a better man. The support staff that I had around there, and then also the relationship I had with Coach Gillespie was very strong. How he was going to make me a better man, very similar. Alabama and Buford are very similar. I say that all the time. And I just see so many similarities in those two programs, and that's why they both continue to win day in and day out.
If his name sounds familiar, that's because his dad is Verron Haynes, the famous Georgia running back involved in the hobnail boot call by Larry Munson. I asked Justice about that, too, so don't miss the full interview on this week's episode of Recruiting 2022. You can watch it at gpb.org/sports, or it will re-air right after the postgame show. Stay with us. We'll take a look around the rest of the state and check in with John at Tom Ryden Stadium right after this.
Buckle up, Georgia is back on the road. And this week, we stopped at Chattahoochee High School to show our VR crash to their school's SAD chapter.
SAD stands for Students Against Destructive Decisions. And in our club, we really focus on our students being peer-to-peer, really trying to reach out to their peers and share the dangers of distracted driving, driving under the influence, not wearing your seatbelt.
I think SAD is really important because it helps spread our message throughout the community, which is really making sure that students are really safe and what's happening around us and just aware of like the different issues that happen.
So we showed these safe drivers what happens when things go off the road.
So that was really immersive to see this rollover that was happening at just 60 miles an hour. And I feel like for our students who are driving, this would be amazing for them to see it. And then also for our students who aren't driving yet, just to kind of have that realization as they're preparing to go behind the wheel.
It was really heart-wrenching to kind of see how much of an impact it had without their seatbelt. This could happen to me. This could happen to any of the passengers in my car. So it would really make a long-lasting effect.
I think it does a great job at demonstrating like how dangerous simply not wearing your seatbelt can be.
When I'm driving, I'm not moving until my friends have their seatbelts on.
It really shows our students and drivers that the message is clear. You really need to buckle up.
You can also check out our VR rollover crash by going to gpb.org/buckleupgeorgia.
Did you get it?
Of course.
Forgetting something?
Really? Fine. Happy?
If you're a Georgia high school student, go to gpb.org/buckleupgeorgia, enter the contest, and create your own seatbelt safety promo.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Cigna. Together all the way. Cigna is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna's mission is to improve the health, well-being, and peace of mind of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your best, got me feeling some kind of way.
Of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
overtime of Mill Creek versus Buford. Wolves on top 25-14, and it's homecoming at Buford tonight. Congratulations to everyone on the different courts. Let's take a look at some of the top games happening around the state on Georgia's EMC scoreboard. Georgia's EMC's so much more than electricity. In South Georgia, Early County is 7-0 and has already clinched the Region 1 Single-A Division 2 title. The Bobcats started the season off with all region games and now have three non-Region 1s left to go. What a strategy, including Brooks County, who hasn't played in 3 weeks, but that doesn't matter. Trojans are losing 14-7. Let's go up north for two ranked and unbeaten teams battling it out for the top spot in Region 8 Single-A Division 1. Raven County leading Elbert County 14-0 in the second. In Cobb County, Cambridge versus Kell is also one for the lead in Region 6-5A. The Bears are leading Kell 21-3 in the second. In the east, Aquinas versus Lincoln County is a great game in Region 8 Single-A Division 2. That one's tied at 7. And a Central Georgia Region 2 AAA rivalry with two great defenses underway in Fort Valley. Peach County leading Mary Persons 14-3. For more scores and to take our game with you on the go, download the GPB Sports app by scanning the QR code on the screen throughout the night. Time now to check in with John Nelson. And John, our web game is a Region 2 5A matchup between Jones County and Dutchtown. It's offense versus defense in that one. What's happening in Hampton right now?
14-7 was the last update that we had. Jones County jumped out to the early lead with that offense that we were talking about, but then onside kick, and that's the kind of riverboat gambler sometimes that you'll see from Mike Chastain, especially with his time with the Greyhounds, because of how high-powered and how rhythmic that offense can be. They put 14 points on the board, kind of put Dutchtown on their heels a little bit. Dutchtown with a score to close the margins a little bit, but should be early third quarter now with Jones County leading Dutchtown. Anybody can catch that one at gpb.org, also on the web for your multi-screen experience tonight.
John, back there in Tom Ryden Stadium, what a first half. A couple of really cool play calls by Coach App. How would you break down the first half there?
Momentum. And when the field tilts the way that it does, it's up to Josh Lovelady and Mill Creek to kind of stop all that momentum that we saw. And you see the depth that Buford has with tight ends and halfbacks and all of these different angles, fourth receivers active in patterns, things like that. Things that we see with the tradition of Buford, and you've seen it on display here in the first half. But then Mill Creek, down 19, got the score. You also got to see Caleb Downs and how active he and Jamal Anderson can be on offense as well to close that margin to 11. It'll be interesting to hear what Coach Lovelady talked to the guys about at halftime to continue to close the margins. You saw that late stand where they had Buford pinned in, but Buford called the fake punt. So you've seen the defense of Mill Creek really clamp down a little bit. Key is, can they continue that third quarter to close the margins in less than 11?
It's going to be quite the halftime speech by Coach Lovelady. Thanks, John. Go take a halftime break, and we'll step aside as well. We'll show you our play of the first half and announce our new TikTok challenge winner next. Cold and flu season, and with COVID rates on the rise again, millions more Americans are expected to get sick this season. How can you tell what's wrong if you're feeling sick? Dr. Robert Hamilton, Senior Medical Director at Cigna, is here to tell us how to recognize the signs and what to do when we feel sick. Dr. Hamilton, what can we do to prevent getting sick?
Well, if you feel sick, stay home. Don't go to work. Don't go to school. Don't get close to other people. You know, the usual hygiene sort of things to prevent the spread of a viral infection, which is what a cold really is.
How can you tell if you have a cold, a flu, COVID, or something else? What should you do to treat it?
Yeah, it's really hard to tell. Even for physicians, it's tough to tell. But the symptoms seem to progress in terms of severity and the duration. So a common cold is just a virus. You have a runny nose, cough, those kind of things, but not too much as far as your whole body. As you get into the flu, you start to have muscle aches. You may feel more fatigue, sleepy all the time. And then when you get into COVID, it can really progress to being very severe. severe fevers, spiking fevers, night sweats, difficulty sleeping, and again, the fatigue and the muscle aches, which is much more pronounced with COVID, a little bit more with flu too, but not so much with the common cold.
And that dreaded cough.
Yes, the cough.
If you get sick, how can you tell if you should see a doctor or if it's serious enough to head right to the ER?
Yeah, there's been a great expansion of what's available through your smartphone, apps, other ways to virtually access care. And so talk to somebody in that manner, run the symptoms by, and then they might be able to guide you better whether you need to go to the doctor's office or to the emergency room.
Dr. Hamilton, thank you so much for being here and for this great information. For more, you can go to Cigna.com.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Georgia's EMCs. So much more than electricity.
As morning light signals the start of business, Georgia's electric membership cooperatives are right there with you. Georgia's EMCs are a partner in economic development, serving commercial accounts big and small that drive Georgia's economy. From leading industries we rely on to local shops we treasure, we support operations on the ground, care around the clock, and growth through the seasons, lighting up good business. So business is good. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
Half of the nation's opioid overdoses happen right at home because people don't understand the dangers of taking an Oxy or Perc with a glass of alcohol for stress or to sleep. Learn how to protect your family from opioid overdose at opioidresponse.info.
Time show presented by Regions. If you're just now joining us, Buford is leading Mill Creek 25-14. Here's our GPB play of the first half. First quarter we go, 2nd and 8 for Buford. Whitkey tosses it to Justin Haynes. He'll throw it lefty down the field to tight end Eli McElwainy on the 1 yard line. That would lead to the first score of the game and a 2-point conversion. Wolves up after all that, 8-0. Time now to announce our winner of the GPB Sports TikTok Challenge, and the winner is the Buford Band of Wolves. Let's take a look. Guys, everyone, go follow us at GPB Sports on TikTok for more information on the challenge. And to cast your vote, it's simple. Just comment on the video you like best with the team's assigned emoji for the week. Next week, our challenge is between 4 teams, our TV game, Carrollton versus Westlake, and our web game, Denmark versus Lambert. Good luck, everyone. I also want to remind you that our flag football coverage has begun. We will be streaming one of the state's best matchups every Thursday evening, and you can watch at gpb.org/sports or on the GPB Sports app. Our flag football games are some of the most watched videos on our GPB Sports YouTube channel, so you do not want to miss watching the ladies. Stick around after the game. It's the GPB Sports postgame show where John and I will hear from coaches all across the state. They will be on standby in the bus or in the locker room or in their office waiting to talk to us after their games. And countdown to kickoff. If you guys don't know, John and I preview everything that's happening around the state and recap this week. It's on Countdown to Kickoff, GPB Sports, Facebook Live every Thursday at noon. So check us out. It's a live interactive show where you can get in the Facebook comments and ask John some questions that we will answer. So we will see you on Thursdays at noon. That's it for the halftime show. Thank you so much for watching. We'll have more from Matt, Wayne, and John right after this. Don't forget, post-game show after the game.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by DBHDV and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is about all Georgians standing together for substance abuse prevention. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your best, got me feeling some kind of way.
Of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
We continue our coverage of National Signing Day. We go now to Atlanta, Georgia for Kevin Connor's official declaration.
After giving it much thought, I've decided that next year I'll be going pro and building my skills as a Georgia plumber!
What impacted your decision?
It was an opportunity to earn money and learn on the job. I really love working with my hands, building things, and being part of a team.
Another highly touted prospect enters the trades.
Go Plumber!
Welcome back in our GPB Sports Studios. Halftime and a 25-14 lead for the Buford Wolves as we get ready for the start of the third quarter. Matt Stewart along with Wayne Gandy. And what a first half. Very exciting first half. And we step into the second half feeling like Mill Creek still has a shot in this game.
When you look at them, they decided that we're going to go with our best players, Jamal Anderson, Caleb Downs. We're going to have to figure out a way to get them the ball, have any chance against this defense, and to get back into this game.
All that said, Buford does still have an 11-point lead. Let's take a look back at those first half highlights. And Justice Haynes threw a big pass on their opening drive, got him down to the one-yard line.
Early pass there, big play. Down the field there to Eli McAvaney, and then Dylan Wickey, just 1 yard quarterback sneak into the end zone.
And then Mill Creek back on offense. Big interception by Jaden Perlotti. Set up a 30-yard field goal by Ventura. And then Mill Creek gets on the board with the 46-yard pass from Clark to Mikel Wood. McElwainy, 22-yard reception. Two big catches from McElwainy in the first half for a young man who had only one catch the entire season. Biggest play of the game, 82-yard punt return by Jordan Allen. And then Caleb Downs took over, had three touches on that touchdown drive of 80 yards. 6-yard touchdown run right there. As you take a look at the stats, they're pretty even considering that's a 25-14 game.
Yeah, when you go into this game, both teams had their moments. Buford in that first quarter, like they were just going to dominate this game. And then Mill Creek right there in the end of that second quarter started to get back into the game. They're going to have to clean up some things, especially with the penalties. But they're giving themselves a chance in the second half.
And you see the two turnovers, as always seems to be the case. Look to that number to tell you the story of the game. The two turnovers played big in the 11-point lead for Buford.
It gave them a chance, and Buford took advantage of every opportunity with the short field. They got into the end zone, and now can they come out and do they get that run game going with Haynes, try to establish that? And how does Mill Creek get down the field? They really put a lot of drives together. They had some big plays here and there to make up some yardage, and their big players are going to have to play again both ways on both sides of the ball to make plays.
And kind of a quiet first half for Justice Haynes, but he's got 116 yards of total offense, the 24-yard pass, and nearly 100 yards rushing.
And that's the key to them. I think they're going to have to establish that run game. We saw a couple of those runs. He was one little missed tackle from a big field, big yardage. But Mill Creek keeping themselves around, showing you why they're ranked so high.
Just an absolute fabulous environment tonight here at Tom Ryden Stadium. Sell out, standing room only. Let's send it to John, standing by with Coach Lovelady.
Thank you very much, Matt. Here with the coach. You got the touchdown that closed the margin to 11. Seemed like that second half of the second quarter you were taking the way, control the way that you wanted to.
Yeah, we had settled in. You know what I'm saying? You got a great team in Buford. You can't sit there and bust two coverages.
And give up some wide open plays. Had a turnover in there, too. So I think we had to get the motion out of that, you know, the game and just settle in and be ourselves.
And I know at the same time, the penalties and the turnovers in the first quarter put you in that early hole. What were the conversations like back there in the field house?
Just be who we are. Be Mill Creek football. Play clean. Play fast and physical. All right? And let the scoreboard take care of itself. I think we got the offense on the field right here. It's a big drive here. Open it up. And let's go play some ball. Thank you.
Josh Lovelady, the head coach of Mill Creek, down 11, but he's going to get the ball, Matt, to start the third quarter.
Thanks, Nelly. And Wayne, that's what made that fake punt by Buford so big, because had they given the ball back to Mill Creek, Mill Creek would have had consecutive possessions because they're getting the ball first here in the third quarter.
And Coach Appleton said that at half, that he recognized it was not a good time to give them that ball back with the momentum they had. He had to figure out a way to end the half with the ball. He came up big with Haynes picking up about 30 yards on that fourth and three.
So ready to start this third quarter, as I was saying when we broke away for the interview with Lovelady, 8,000 tickets sold prior to the game, so who knows what the exact attendance is with the walk-up, but standing room only about an hour before kickoff. They had already sold out all the seats. No more seats to be had there at Tom Ryden Stadium, which is probably the biggest regular season game ever here at this great ballpark, the Buford Wolves. So the second half kickoff is brought to you by Buckle Up Georgia. Buckle Up Georgia, seat belts save lives. And Buford will be kicking off to start this third quarter. Mario Ventura has it teed up. They've been pooch kicking most of the half ever since Caleb Downs had a 38-yard kickoff return in that first half.
Definitely doing a good job of not letting him affect the game in the special teams. Right there, you could see like Jenkins is back on this return for Mill Creek.
And they will pop it up again. Fair catch called for, made at the 32-yard line by Content. And so that's where Mill Creek goes on offense. See if they can get something going here. Has it been a great first half for their solid quarterback, Hayden Clark, 5 of 13 for 101 yards. Did throw the 46-yard touchdown pass to Mikel Wood, also threw a two-point conversion, but also had a critical interception, his first of the season.
They have to come out in this half, clean up those penalties, stay out of third and long against this defense. As we can talk about all night long, Houston, Williams and those guys, Pilati can rush the passer in those situations.
Handoff goes Cam Robinson. He struggles to get back to the line of scrimmage. Edrick Houston in on that tackle, four tackles and a TFL for Edrick Houston so far in this game.
Houston gets the tackle, but Walker, the inside linebacker, is screaming through that gap. Didn't come up with the tackle, but hit, made the initial hit in the backfield there on Robinson.
Second down and 9. Low snap. Clark, pressure, forces him out of the pocket. And he's going to barely get back to the line of scrimmage. Great pursuit by that Buford defense. Mantrez Walker there to finish it off.
Only a 3-man rush. Once again, just not feel comfortable with the route. Gets outside. Jordan Pilati, as we talked about, only a sophomore. Playing a little safety right there. What a bright future. 6'4", 205 coming in. He's outside linebacker, but coming into that play looking like a safety.
Third down and 8.
This is the down Buford wants to get them in. They want to pressure them up front. Can the O-line hold up with only a 3-man rush?
Pressure coming off the edge. Clark gets it out of there. Close to a first down on the throw to Jenkins.
Big tackle there by K.J. Poten. Young junior, the 5-star. A lot of room out there. Jenkins, good play design. Wide receiver screen. This team in the receiving corps known for blocking out on the edge for each other, but nice tackle there for Bolden, fourth and one. Their side of the field, you imagine they're going to punt this ball.
Brendan Jenkins, 11 offers, including William and Mary, Richmond, Middle Tennessee, and Army. Fourth and one, they're punting, or do they fake it?
Some Buford players yelling, watch the fake.
Delay a game. Offense, 5-yard penalty, still fourth down.
Well, you would think that they're punting it right here. Ulrich, the junior punter, big kid, 6'6", 190, featured on our Make That Kid an Offer segment in Recruiting 2022 tonight. Does have one offer from Stetson. Boots it out of there. Fair catch called for, made at the 27 by Jordan Allen, who already has an 82-yard punt return touchdown tonight. That was a 37-yard kick by Ulrich, and Buford goes on offense here for the first time in the third quarter.
Now it falls on this Mill Creek defense to try to slow down this Buford offense. Kind of fell asleep there in the second quarter after they took control of the game, but can they pick up that poise and passion they were playing with early in the game? Whitkey making some plays, moving his feet, running the ball.
On first and 10, Justice Haynes gets about 7 on the play. Anglin in on that tackle for Mill Creek.
Such a patient runner out in space. Seems like he's not pressed, as almost running at in a space like he's not actually have the ball. You almost think he's faking like he has the ball. But a big pickup and a great time to get him going. And as we talked about, so deep in the running back. You get 9 yards and then you go to the sideline. Only in Buford does that happen.
13 carries, 100 yards even for Haynes tonight. Second down and 2. Hand off and Baker, Justin Baker gets the first down. Nick Maxey finally gets him on the ground, but that's a first down carry for Justin Baker.
Really like the energy that Baker brings into this game. Only a sophomore, 5'10", about 200 pounds. You see this physical between the tackles here. This one cut, legs driving, trying to earn some time out on the field.
I was getting ready to say, that's why he's got energy, because when you get your chance, you better bring it, right?
You gotta go as a sophomore, young guy, such a deep team, rotating a lot of bodies.
Nick Maxey is being helped off the field. Maxey, 6'4", 210, senior defensive end, committed to North Greenville. This is the Friday night environment that you picture. When they create a movie about football on Friday nights, this is the environment they're trying to capture.
As you get a high school crowd at the game 2 hours before, that's a lot. Stands full of people.
First and 10. Haynes on the carry again. Metz making the tackle.
Good penetration there by the nose tackle, Boltwell. Pushing the center back about 3 yards. Not giving Haynes any room to make a cut.
Chose Alabama during the summer. 35 other offers, including Georgia, Ohio State, and Florida. And he just like announced on a Saturday afternoon, didn't have a big elaborate ceremony, just popped up on Twitter and said, I'm committed to Alabama. Handoff goes to Haynes, gotta watch out. There he goes, across the 40, the 30. Content, the man to beat, the cutback, touchdown, Justice Haynes.
And this is that big play ability we talked about in the open. This is what makes this young man such a danger. We saw a couple of times that he was a tackle away from getting in this situation. You cannot let him get to the foot race. He has blazing speed, as you can see here, finally getting to the edge. Good blocking, zone blocking up front. Nice job by Elijah Williams, the linebacker on the kick out. And now it's just about the speed and talent of this young man. What a weapon, so dangerous. And those are the big hits that his kind of talent brings to the field.
56-yard touchdown run for Justice Haynes. Kick is up and good. Buford makes good on their opening possession of the third quarter. And Justice Haynes, the five-star running back, ranked number two in the nation, showing off his talent as Buford takes an 18-point lead.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by DBHDD. Win by learning about safe usage of prescription opioids.
Half of the nation's opioid overdoses happen right at home because people don't understand the dangers of taking an Oxy or Perc with a glass of alcohol for stress or to sleep. Learn how to protect your family from opioid overdose at opioidresponse.info.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
When you work on your own terms, every day feels like Friday. That's why at Friday Health Plans, we provide health insurance for professionals who do just that. Independents, freedom seekers, those who follow their own career path, even if it doesn't come with a company health plan. Open enrollment for 2023 health insurance starts November 1st. Friday Health Plans, for people who buy their own health insurance.
Four minutes into the third quarter, Justice Haynes takes off on a 56-yard touchdown run. As we take a look at Buford's top prospects, K.J. Bolden, five-star junior, 50 offers. Edric Houston, five-star junior, 40 offers. Jaden Perlotti, five-star sophomore, 35 offers. Then you get to Justice Haynes, five-star, number two running back in the country, committed to Alabama. And Tyshawn White, four-star safety, with 41 offers. And that's just the tip of the iceberg. They've got 24 players on this Buford team with college football offers.
A lot of talented players that just had to sit behind other guys that moved on to college.
Again, the pop-up kick as they keep the ball away from Caleb Downs. You got to wonder, they keep doing it. They've kicked it to content every time. Do you sneak Caleb Downs up there? You know, kind of sneak him up there for that pop-up kick?
Definitely.
They keep kicking it to the same spot every time.
Switch him up there and make them force them to kick the ball off. Right now, this Mill Creek offense, you feel like they got to get a score, and they got to get it fast. They got to get back into this game. Buford has come out and run the ball in this second half.
Yeah, when they had it fourth and one right there, they maybe made a mistake by kicking it away because they've got to score on almost every possession at this point. Caleb Downs making magic, 9-yard pickup out there on the edge. Perlotti with the tackle.
Nice tackle out in the open field by K.J. Bolden. And the thing about having to play Caleb Downs both ways to make an impact is that he's playing against other college-level players. It's taking more out of him to make this performance. A lot of times you can do that when the talent that you're playing against is a little less, but he's getting a taste that you can't really do that both ways thing at the next level.
Second down and one. Clark up top, man wide open and missed him. Kel Wood had beat his man, Kobe Blackwell, out there. Would have been a touchdown.
Once again, we saw this earlier for a touchdown, trying to get Wood and Blackwell out. A little action to the right, going back, and just not capitalizing three or four steps there on Blackwell is Woods. And those are the kind of plays, those quick strikes, they're going to have a couple of those to keep pace.
Big miss right there. Now it's third down and one. Handoff. Robinson going to get the first down. How about that? Lowers his helmet right into Edrick Houston and still gets the first down.
Nice job of him making Elijah Williams, number nine for Buford. So much penetration, almost took the handoff, just missed the tackle. Then his buddy right there, Edrick Houston, coming in, trying to hold him, but having to throw him for the first down.
Been impressed by Cam Robinson tonight. It's been tough yardage. He's not a big kid. He's shown a lot of tenacity. Handoff goes Caleb Downs, going to go the other way and get positive yardage out of what was probably going to be a negative play.
Caleb Downs. He gained 3 yards.
And this is all about the penetration up the field. Just nowhere to go on that right side, forcing Downs to cut back. And as I said, a lot of times those are the big plays he might make against other teams. But when you're playing Buford, there's 6, 8, 10 players on that defense that also are going to the next level.
Rated the number 12 overall national prospect, regardless of position. Second down and 7. Clark going to run and get the first down across midfield to the 49-yard line.
Nice decision there by Clark. McKinnis, number 8, the linebacker, took away Downs out on the edge. You can see he wanted to go to Downs on the outside, deciding to do it with his feet. We talked about it in the open. It's just one of those smart game managers that have that athletic ability to pick up those third, second, and shorts.
So first and 10. Handoff goes. Caleb Downs dances to the outside. My goodness, watch him go inside the 20 and finally cut down at the 16-yard line by Devin Williams.
What a great athlete. We're talking about a man that has rarely leaves the field and still making cuts like this. Right here, a little stutter step. And now I'm just doing my thing out in the open. Speed, size, physicality at the end of the run.
33-yard pickup. Downs 4 carries, 63 yards rushing in this game. Just a tremendous athlete, and I hope you're able, watching at home, to, you know, really sense his talent level and the players he's playing against here tonight and still showing that talent level.
Definitely seems to be at a different level than the other players on the field. And in high school, I was both way defensive line, offensive line. It takes a lot out of you never to leave the field.
Clark fires it complete to Wood, and Wood's going to have the first down. Let's see where they spot it. If they give him the forward motion, that's a first down. Looks like they're going to spot him maybe a yard short. I thought he'd caught it at the 4. They spot it a little bit outside the 5, but it is a first down, first and goal to go. Did get the first down.
Nice job on that stop, Rye. Nice quarterback by Clark, keeping that ball high so the corner can't knock it out. And Mikael Wood has just come alive in this game and put his imprint on it.
Yeah, he's a great talent, committed to Eastern Michigan. Size is the only thing that probably keeps him from staying in the Southeast and playing Power 5. Now going Wildcat with Caleb Downs taking the direct snap. And gets stopped at the line of scrimmage. He got to the 5.
Once again, showing you it takes 4 or 5 bodies to bring him down. He just looks physically impressive. It's like he's been in a different kind of training than the other guys.
His dad, of course, played in the National Football League. His dad, Gary, who's now the running backs coach and recruiting coordinator at East Tennessee State. His brother, Josh Jr., all ACC wide receiver at North Carolina. Wood up top, jump ball caught for the touchdown. Brendan Jenkins, Mill Creek coming back. 5-yard touchdown pass makes it 32-20.
Nice job of creating space. The big receiver, Brendan Jenkins, 6'2", about 200 pounds. Little corner route to the back of the end zone, catching it at the high apex of the route. Nice job by him on the shorter, Kobe Blackwell. The touchdowns look like they are setting up to go for two in this situation.
Yeah, we want to try to make it a 10-point game here where a touchdown and a field goal gets you tied.
Wildcat once again with Caleb Downs in the backfield.
Downs going to go to the far side and not going to get there. Great pursuit by Tyshawn White, the four-star safety, to come up and deny the two-point conversion. But Mill Creek keeps hanging around. A big touchdown drive right there. A lot of Caleb Downs, and then the touchdown pass from Clark to Jenkins makes it 32-20.
Cigna is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna's mission is to improve the health, well-being, and peace of mind of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being. DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is about all Georgians standing together for substance abuse prevention. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
Every game day celebration, every championship title begins here with hours of unseen work. As part of our commitment to education, Georgia's EMC support the young athletes who play high school sports in the communities we serve. Empowering talent with scholarships, honoring sportsmanship, saluting the game changers. When we champion the energy behind the scenes, they can step into their future and shine. Georgia's EMCs, official energy provider of the GHSA.
All right, what do you think, Jasper?
Honestly, I think that polyester shirt's faking your game.
What?
I think cotton would have been a better choice.
Cotton?
Yeah, it's come a long way, you know. Nowadays, cotton breathes and makes moisture great. Plus, buying cotton means supporting Georgia farmers. I think that's wonderful.
Okay, sure, but what do you think about the putt?
Oh, guess really hadn't thought about it.
Welcome back to Tom Ryden, 3:18 for the third, and the margin is 12 on behalf of Buford. Let's get into the multi-screen experience quickly. Let you see what's going on between Jones County and Dutchtown. This one, as always, brought to us by our friends at Breda Pest Management, the official pest control of high school football. It is fourth quarter, and the lead is 24-7 Jones County. Big lead for them in a big region game going up against a very, very tough defense in Dutchtown. Some teams already in the barn tonight. Benedictine with a big win. Fitzgerald with a big win. And we're keeping an eye on teams as we get closer and closer to the postgame show. Let's send it back to 260-14 for the remainder of the third quarter. Matt.
Nellie, Jones County looking like they're playing tonight like we anticipated them playing all season long. That would be a big win tonight against Nikita Battle and the Dutchtown Bulldogs. Here we have 3:18 left in the quarter. Mill Creek has battled back. They've cut the Buford lead to 32-20. Kick coming down at the one. Returned by Justice Haynes. And Haynes still on his feet somehow up to the 38-yard line. What a return by Justice Haynes.
Ooh, Justice in the back end on this kick return. He just never seems to be stressed. Just moving along, trusses in his speed right there, and then just explodes for 20, 30 yards. And right here, just driving those legs, great balance.
And right there, Wayne, 1 yard equaled 17. If Ulrich can kick it 1 yard deeper into the end zone, Buford has it at the 20 instead of the 37.
Really has come alive, as you talked about in that first half, effective but quiet first half. Now showing you why he's headed to Alabama.
Yeah, he's got 156 yards rushing, 24 yards passing. Right there, that was a 37-yard kick return.
Snap infraction. 5 yard penalty. Still first down.
You kind of get the feeling that when we get to this fourth quarter, we're headed towards exactly what we talked about off the top. Caleb Downs versus Justice Haynes. Which one's going to win that fourth quarter, right? Haynes got a little bit of advantage because he's got the 12-point lead. Short gain for Buford up to the 35-yard line. That was Justin Baker on the carry.
Good to see Paul Dingo back in the game in this second half. He went out earlier, having to be helped off the field. Good to see him, the big left tackle, three-star, headed to LSU.
How about Buford? They've got power five tackles. Devin Forrester on the right side is a three-star junior with offers from Penn State, Florida State, Arkansas, and Arkansas State. Great luxury to have. Running the screen to K.J. Bolden. He gets cut down at the 40-yard line. Little gain for K.J. Bolden right there. Caleb Towns coming up to make that tackle.
And those are the kind of plays I think Buford needs to continue to dial up for K.J. Bolden. Just plays where you get him the ball. And no route to it. We'll start trying to get his athletic ability going. And then Caleb Towns coming to clean up things out on the edge.
Third down and eight.
Young man must get some good sleep at night after these games with the way he flies around.
K.J. Bolden is five-star, number one ranked safety in the junior class. Whitke scrambling. Going to take a sack. Ball is out. Mill Creek has recovered at the 26. Metz recovers the fumble. Now the referee is calling that an incomplete pass. I'm not sure how that could be an incomplete pass. I'd have to see the replay.
Nick Derrick, number 25 here, coming in.
Oh, my goodness.
That ball is out. Hitting the ball with his helmet, knocking the ball out, never really getting the arm going forward is Whitke.
And Nick Denick coming with the pressure, number 25 right there. That, folks, is not an incomplete pass. They missed that one. Fair catch is called for. Looked like he might have been interfered with for a moment. Still makes the catch at the 26-yard line. But a tough break for Mill Creek. Had there been replay, that certainly would have been reviewed.
Nice job of the defense finally getting some pressure, getting their offense this ball back in a hurry, something they need. They're going to need many opportunities, quick strikes, big plays. And how effective, as you talked about in the fourth quarter, is Caleb Downs going to be having to do all this work?
You can see Josh Lovelady, he's still upset, and rightfully so, about that incomplete pass call. They would have had the ball inside the 25-yard line or thereabouts. Now they take over at their own 21. Clark to the air. Wood tried to reach behind and make a great catch and couldn't come up with it.
You can see Clark. Woods has been his number one target, his go-to guy. Those guys have a good connection. And every time he looks over and he sees him in a one-on-one situation with Buford, likes to dial up. He likes to be able to stack that box to stop the run and play man out on the corner. Clark and Woods are deciding they're going to attack it.
Wood has three catches for 62 yards tonight. One a 46-yard touchdown catch. They go back the other way. Nearly intercepted at the 34-yard line by Tyshawn White.
Nice job of White falling back into this play. A soft zone on the back end. You could see him just falling in, reading the quarterback's eye. Just inches away from intercepting that ball. Come up with a big play for his defense. But this defense now third and 10. These are the situations they came in this game wanting to create. And now can his D-line get the pressure?
Third down and 10. 4 of 7 passing. Clark here in the second half. It's going to be on Mill Creek.
There's going to be a false start out here.
Prior to the snap, encroachment. Offense lined up over the neutral zone. 5-yard penalty for third down.
I don't know if you can have encroachment.
Well, I think they interpret that as lining up in the neutral zone.
Okay.
So you're typically used to the encroachment call coming on defense, but because the offensive player lined up in the neutral zone. The official called it encroachment. So third and 15. Letting it air out, and Wood nearly came up with it. Devin Williams, the corner, was just running stride for stride with it. And it's fourth down.
Nice job by Williams. Only 5'10", this is about 150, not the biggest of corners, but speedy. Step for step, head around, you can see right there. Cornerbacks are allowed a little more touching when they get the head around and identify the ball. Nice job knocking that ball away.
And he did a great job. You saw his trailing arm. He made sure he had a grasp of that wide receiver too. And the kick is out of there. Somehow Ulrich got it out of there and has fumbled. And let's see who's got it. Battle for it at the 41-yard line. We've already seen one signal for Mill Creek. And it is Mill Creek's ball. Jordan Allen, who had an 82-yard punt return touchdown in the first half, makes a mistake here late in the third quarter and gives the Hawks the ball around the 40-yard line.
Allen doing the right thing, called for the fair catch, and just didn't get in front of the ball. As you can see, got his hands on it as he was falling down.
Caleb Buckman recovered the fumble. First turnover for Buford in this game. See if the Hawks take an immediate shot at the end zone here. They do. Going for the home run. And penalty flags out. Devin Williams this time will be called for the PI.
Can't emphasize enough this Clark to Wood situation. Anytime that Hayden Clark sees Mikael Wood in a one-on-one situation, he's running just flat-out go routes.
Pass interference. Defense. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot will result. First down.
He is their deep threat receiver. There's nothing fancy about these routes. It's a belief that he is a better receiver than your corner. You can see Devin Williams grabbing once again. Clear pass interference right there. Desperation time for Williams. He's beat on the route.
From the 25-yard line, first snap goes to Caleb Downs. He gets a couple of yards.
Stop was made by number 51.
So this is the opportunity that Mill Creek has been looking for. If they can cash in and score, we've got a one-score game in the fourth quarter. What a battle between these two teams playing each other for the first time ever. Second down and 8, running a reverse to Jenkins. Clark out there blocking for him. Down to the 20-yard line.
Nice job by KJ Bolden. Not letting this become a big play. Keeping to the outside, forcing Clark on the reverse, Jenkins on the reverse to cut this back in. But you'll see Buford, number one, Bolden comes up. If he doesn't keep this play to the inside, that's going to be a big play.
And that is the end of the third quarter. 32-20, Buford on top. As we head to the final 12 minutes, Mill Creek with a chance to get closer than they've been since early in this ballgame.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Regions Bank. Get back in the game with Regions Bank.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your well.
I got it, Mom. It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your best, got me feeling some kind of way.
Of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
Half of the nation's opioid overdoses happen right at home because people don't understand the dangers of taking an Oxy or Perc with a glass of alcohol for stress or to sleep. Learn how to protect your family from opioid overdose at opioidresponse.info.
Number one Buford on top of number three Mill Creek as we head to the fourth quarter. Our final live look-in brought to you by Breda Pest Management. And Jones County has come up with the big win tonight at Dutchtown as the Greyhounds beat the Bulldogs 24-7, the final there. Breda Pest Management, official pest control of high school football. And stick around when this game is over. It isn't over. Post-game show with Hannah Gooden, John Nelson coming up. We'll have all the big scores and interviews across the state. Here it's third and four as we start the fourth. Clark going to the end zone, and Caleb Downs had flashed open for a moment, got matched up with the linebacker, and it's fourth and four.
Nice job of rubbing the linebacker, Jaden Perlotti, off there on the route by Caleb Downs. Just needed the quarterback to hold the ball just another second so he could break free. But here, fourth and four, Mill Creek and this offense has decided to go for it in this situation.
Yeah, can't settle for the field goal here. Fourth and four. Line to gain is the 16. Clark, 9 of 21 passing, 131, couple of touchdowns. And a timeout called by Buford. That'll be the first that they've used here in the second half.
Buford.
And we'll step aside with this big fourth and four coming up when we get back.
Well, we've got a quick break in the action. Did you know that the same area of just one football field can contain up to 95 termite colonies? That's why you need Breda Pest Management to defend your home. Breda, the official pest control of high school football.
DVHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is about all Georgians standing together for substance abuse prevention. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
The Georgia Department of Community Affairs and the Georgia Rental Assistance Program, currently helping Georgians with rent, utilities, and other housing expenses. They will pay the landlord or utility provider directly for these expenses even after an eviction. If you, a friend, or family member knows someone who could use this assistance, paymyrent.ga.gov provides program details and explains how to apply for relief. Paymyrent.ga.gov can help. Help is here.
Cigna is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna's mission is to improve the health, well-being, and peace of mind of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being.
Stadium, fourth and four coming up for Mill Creek. Wayne, where's the ball going?
You imagine in this situation, you got to get the ball to Caleb Downs. He's your guy, especially in the red zone, one of those guys that with the ball in his hand, he can make guys miss and pick up the first down with just his natural running ability.
Do you run some kind of a screen for him? He might be in that bunch up there. That might be where the ball's going with the screen play. Let's see. Tried to get Buford to jump right there. They weren't biting. Huge play to start this fourth quarter, essentially. And there goes Cam Robinson. Instead, fires in the middle, and that's a first down catch for Caleb Downs.
Nice route combination up top in that trip set. Caleb's down just working really a crossing route here, making sure he makes himself big right there in the middle of that zone to come up with this little slant route. Nice job, great hands. And as I continue to say, one of those guys, you really have to make a decision on what side of the ball you want to play him on.
Clark under pressure, helmet comes off. He's going to have to come off the field unless they call a timeout. And hopefully he's okay. He might have hit his head hard on the field there, forcing that helmet to come off. You saw him lean forward. Now he's up. Yeah, he's hurting.
Big pressure up the field here. You could see Edrick Houston just working around.
Oh, yeah, he got hit in the back of the head.
Working around the tackle, Jax Murphy. Right here at the end.
Yep, got hit in the back of the head. He's going to have to come off the field. Shane Throgmorton is their backup quarterback, a sophomore. That was Christian Butler. No ill intent meeting. He was just coming up to make the tackle, and his arm hit Clark in the back of the helmet as he was going down. So Throgmorton in there. Actually not. They're just going to go Wildcat, keep Caleb Downs in there, let him just take the snap.
We talked about it in the open. You talked about it, Matt. You have to watch Caleb Downs throwing this ball in this situation. Don't fall asleep if you're Buford, that he's just going to run this Wildcat and run the ball.
Second and 11. He is just going to run it, and he's going to take it into the end zone for the Mill Creek touchdown. 11-yard touchdown run. We are not done in Buford. 32-26.
Great blocking, similar to his touchdown earlier in the game. Lead blocker Cam Robinson kicking out. And here's just about the talent, the vision, the size, strength right there, stiff arming K.J. Bolden into the end zone, the difference maker, Caleb Downs.
Ulrich on for the PAT. And it is a 32-27 game. Wow. We are set up for some kind of a fourth quarter here.
Nice job on that left side center there with the zone blocking. Vision, look at the ability right there to cut in the middle of the defense. Such a dangerous weapon. And at no point when Caleb Downs has the ball in his hands, do you think safety, you think star running back all the way.
Yeah, that, you get the idea that when he gets to Alabama, I mean, he'll be able to do, you know, kind of whatever he wants to do. I mean, I know Saban's going to obviously have a, but he could do what I mean from a talent standpoint. If he needs to play running back, he can certainly do that. Working on that calf muscle on his left leg. Six play, 41-yard drive after the fumbled punt return. And we have not been this close since the opening touchdown of the game, scored by Buford. In fact, Buford once led 25-6 in this game. Pop-up kick is fielded at the 30-yard line. And that's where Buford goes on offense. So the coaches came out to watch this one tonight. And Ryan Day from Ohio State made sure he was here tonight to see this cavalcade of stars on both sides of the ball.
Calling his recruitment department, asking him, do you think we need to make another run at this Caleb Downs? What a dominant performance. Great game for not just coaches but fans. The two of us watching right now finally turning into that heavyweight slug fest that we thought.
So first and 10, Dylan Whitkey, the quarterback, gonna keep it. And Whitkey falls forward, picks up about four on the play, and a flag out. Had something happen at the end of the play after Nick Denick had made the tackle.
think he's a little hampered there as he runs to the sideline.
Might have had his ankle twisted as he was tackled. Yeah, that's exactly what he did. That's what I was getting ready to say. I wouldn't put it past a defensive player to twist an ankle at the end of a tackle. They've been known to do that.
Following the play, dead ball, personal foul on the defense. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run. Results.
That was number 25, Nick Bennett.
Yep.
The senior, and those kind of plays, you just can't give up that kind of yardage, 15 yards in this situation. The defense has been humming.
I mean,
just a bad play. This is a bad football play. This is not part of the game at all. This is what we've tried to clean up over the years. That is intentional. That has nothing to do with football there by that young man. I'm quite sure he just caught up in his emotions at the moment.
Play the game clean. First and 10 ball at the 49-yard line. Whitkey stays in there, dumps it off to Traylon Maddox. First time he's touched the ball tonight. Listed as a backup linebacker. He gets some touches in the backfield every once in a while, and that's his first of the night.
Nice job leading Maddox here, keeping it high to the tall receiver. Just an extension of the run game to get him out in the flat, get him the ball, get 5, 6, 7 yards to keep this drive going.
Caleb Downs, for everything, you take a look at the resume there, recruiting resume for Maddox. And the hurdle, and a first down. And a flag out after Justice Haynes had hurdled for the first down.
It's a little toss to the outside. He's trying to jump over the defender. Picked up the first down.
And there is a flag.
Interesting call of what they're calling Haynes for. Having his knee up in that situation, not sure.
We'll find out here in a moment.
Personal foul, hurdling. 15-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Replay, second down.
New one for me.
Right here, just trying to get the first down. Thought that. I'm not real sure. Caleb Downs goes low. He jumps over him. I'm not sure what that call is right there, madam.
Yeah.
I've never heard of hurdling as
a penalty. You see it all the time.
Penalty.
But apparently in the high school football rule book, hurdling is a personal foul. Backs him up to the 44-yard line. On the carry, got all of it back. They're trying to strip him of the ball. You see Jamal Anderson reaching in there, wrestling with Justice Haynes all the way to the ground. 21-yard pickup.
Matt, this is becoming the battle of Bama.
Yeah.
Bama against Bama. Justice Haynes making big play after big play for this offense. You could just see him at the end carrying 4 or 5 guys for another 5 yards.
Jamal Anderson, they make sure he gets clear. The officials give him an escort out of that pile of Buford Wolves.
Great blocking up front. And now just look at Haynes, the effort to make these plays. Right there, Anderson pulling him down. A lot of bodies.
Yeah, emotions are running high. A flag just came out. And you can see the coaches are upset with Jamal Anderson.
I'm not sure. Did he get ejected? Did he go to the sideline like he may have been thrown out of the game?
Josh Lovelady, you can see he's all the way across the field. He's all the way across on the Buford side of the field. He's upset with the call. We'll try to get a clarification. Here comes Patrick Ingram, our referee. He's going to tell us here in a moment. Well, they're still talking about it. We didn't see everything that happened once, you know, they kind of went into that pile on the sideline. Our view was obscured from that.
Originally, you could see Jamal Anderson saying something to Coach Afflin. And he went to the ref, and as Anderson went to the sideline, it looked like it might be a big call against Mill Creek and give Buford 15 yards.
So in sportsmanlike conduct, we're reading lips there. We couldn't hear the audio. But on sportsmanlike conduct. So keep an eye on the play right here. Yep, he's ripping his helmet off. Looked like he was trying to rip Justice Haynes' helmet off. And then whatever happens down there is anybody's guess. We can't see. And so a 15-yard penalty gives Buford the ball at the 20-yard line. Justice Haynes stops, redirects himself down to about the 15-yard line. He's headed towards a 200-yard rushing night.
Big second half, making big plays, big kickoff return, finishing runs, carrying bodies.
17 carries for 182 yards and a touchdown. Second down and six. Now under 9 minutes to play in regulation. Blitz is coming. Haynes runs past it. Inside the 10. Touchdown, Buford.
Great job by Justice Haynes. Zone blocking there on that left side. Ian Chandler, the center, watching it all to the left. Cut back lane. Mill Creek coming with the run blitz here. You can see the pressure coming off the edge there by Josh Anglin, just getting up in the line, being able to make the cut cleanly before the blitz gets there, and a big time run there for the touchdown by Haynes.
16-yard touchdown run by Justice Haynes. 18 carries for 197 yards rushing. Had a 24-yard pass that set up their first touchdown. 37-yard kick return here in the second half. He has lived up to the billing. Ventura puts it through. And Buford back up by 12 and time running out on Mill Creek. What a battle we've had tonight here in Buford. The savvy running of Justice Haynes to beat the blitz.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is brought to you in part by Georgia's EMCs. So much more than electricity.
In lively towns and peaceful rural areas, Georgia's Electric Membership Cooperatives are on a mission to provide a different kind of electricity. Our not-for-profit, member-owned EMCs are focused on making life better for members. At private residences, farms, and thriving businesses, we work for you. Generating safe, reliable, affordable electricity, giving back to local programs, serving our members to make life brighter. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
We continue our coverage of National Signing Day. We go now to Atlanta, Georgia for Kevin Connor's official declaration.
After giving it much thought, I've decided that next year I'll be going pro and building my skills as a Georgia plumber!
What impacted your decision?
It was an opportunity to earn money and learn on the job. I really love working with my hands, building things, and being part of a team.
Another highly touted prospect enters the trades.
Go plumber!
D GPHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is about all Georgians standing together for substance abuse prevention. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
Welcome back to Tom Ryden, 8:49 to go, and I'll go ahead and use the R word. Regulation, the margins back to 12 at 39-27. After that last exchange where you saw a lot of flags and a lot of folks in a pile, the Mill Creek coaching staff very upset about the activity going on at the bottom of the pile. They thought a lot of stuff was going on that wasn't being called. Keep an eye on the offense for Mill Creek, Matt, in this upcoming drive. Saw Caleb Downs warming up the arm with a set of gloves on, so we may see that if Hayden Clark cannot go. Let's go back to 260-14, 8:49 to go, Matt.
Thank you, Nelly, for that inside information. No doubt, tempers have flared. It's gotten chippy between these two rivals. It's funny to call them rivals when they're playing for the first time, but because all these kids grew up playing against each other and with each other in Gwinnett Football League when they were younger in middle school, it is a rivalry. Pop-up kick, fair catch made, 33-yard line by Content again. And that's where Mill Creek goes on offense. Let's see if Hayden Clark can come out. Looks like he's got the helmet on, ready to go. Remember, he took that blow to the back of the head on the previous drive. But he's back out there.
Good to see him back in the huddle. How effective would he be after taking that hit? And right now, they're still going to have to work through Caleb Downs consistently. He's been the main target along with Mikael Woods to get them in this game.
You see Caleb Downs, he's lined up here on the hash in that bunch set. Clark scrambles out of there and he gets stopped after a 2-yard gain. Mantrez Walker. Walker, 9 offers, including Florida, Arkansas, South Carolina, Georgia Tech. Walker's just a sophomore. Got a man down. Nico Maggio. Slow to get up. 6'2", 250, sophomore defensive lineman.
Like it might be a cramp. Trying to get some water in that body. As I always say, Matt, only thing about cramps they don't teach you is once they start, that water does not help out. It takes a while trying to massage it.
Buford has won 17 straight. They have not lost a game since September 17th of 2021. When they lost to Florida's 3A number one Chaminade Badana 7-0. They've won 33 of their last 34 games dating back to the 2020 season opener when they lost at North Cobb. So not only do they have the number one ranking on the line here tonight, but also that long 17 game winning streak. And the winner of this ball game will be the overwhelming favorite to be the region champion here in Region 8-7A. Second down and 9. Heavy rush. Clark gets it out of there, and was it caught by Jenkins at the 38. Looks like they're going to rule that a catch. Or not. Nope, bringing the ball back. No catch.
Nice job by defensive end Elijah Williams. The Bowling Green commit. Quick underneath move over and under on the left tackle there. Causing that pressure, causing Clark to have to throw that ball quick. And these are the downs, third and long, that Buford has tried to force all night long, only rushing 3, but getting tremendous pressure when they do.
Clark, 10 of 23, 141, and a couple of touchdowns. Back to the air. Heavy rush. Gets it out of there. Complete to Downs. Caleb Downs does not get the first down. Fourth down right here. You got to go for it, don't you?
Definitely got to go. You imagine you're not going to get a lot of opportunities. You're down 12. You need two scores in this game. And the way that Buford has been able to run the ball, it looks like they're going to punt.
Really surprised that they're punting here when you're down two scores. If you're down one score, I understand. A little surprised here. They got the unit on to punt on a fourth and four.
Buford with their punt safe. Not going to let them run a fake on them.
Allen backtracking, takes the fair catch at the 19, gives Buford the ball with 7.5 minutes to play. Don't know that I like that decision if I'm a Mill Creek fan, because, I mean, you got to score twice. I mean, even if Buford goes three and out here, you're going to burn 2 minutes off the clock.
And you really haven't shown the ability to stop them from getting a couple of first downs. And right now, that's all they're going to want to do. Watch for Wickey to try to just keep the ball, stay in bounds, make this clock a weapon against Mill Creek.
So first and 10 from the 19. Toss goes to Justice Haynes. Haynes gets a solid 5, maybe 6 on the play. That puts him over 200 yards. Actually, that's Justin Baker, pardon me, not 22. It was Justin Baker on the carry that time.
Nice job of Baker. One cut and up the field. Physical runner, as we've seen. Seems excited those couple of times he gets a carry.
You know, put it in perspective. He's the backup running back. He's got an offer from Southern Cal. And he's the backup. Second and 6.
Coming with the run blitz once again. You can see Josh Anglin coming up, inching towards the line. Mill Creek, they understand. We need to stop this run game. 26 right here. Just missing Caleb Downs as well. Nice job. And you can see Justin Baker. He could have kept his feet. There was no one in the back end. Everybody had came up to the line of scrimmage.
Third down and 1. They've already burned a minute off the clock here. And that's Maddox getting his second carry. He picks up the first down.
Big physical body in Maddox. 6'2", about 210, junior, 3-star. I don't know, 7 or 8 3-star juniors returning for this team.
I mean, he's got 15 offers, Penn State, Maryland, Michigan State. They just keep coming at you in waves, don't they? You don't get a break.
When they sub out,
you're not catching a break.
There is a flag on the play.
Five-yard mark off coming up here against the Wolves.
It's Mill Creek defense. A lot of players within a five-yard distance of the ball. He's selling out, trying to stop this run. Only danger with that, when you have these players from Buford, the talent they have, they get a crease. There's no one on the back end to stop them.
First and 15 now. Let's see if that penalty helps out Mill Creek as Maddox gets another carry. That's Trajan Greco, the corner who got him by the ankles to slow him down. Clock's going to be under 5 minutes left in regulation by the time they snap it again.
You really feel with the 12-point difference, this has to be the last set. You can't let Buford get another first down.
No.
At that point, you got 3 timeouts to get another first down. You're going to end up having to burn those. You've got to get off the field on this set of down if you, this Hawk defense.
Justice Haynes now in there. Whitkey rolling to the right, going to try to run for the first down, and he's going to get it. Stepping out of bounds at the 44. That's a real killer right there. So again, you reset that down, and the clock's 4:35. Even if you stop them now and make them punt, you're not going to get the ball back until roughly maybe a little bit over 2 minutes left in the game.
Just taking advantage of the run blitz, the selling out to stop the run, buying the fake, little rollout, a lot of empty space out there, grass for Whitke to make that first down.
That was a 14-yard run for Whitke right there to move the sticks. Baker gets the toss, flag out, and he gets dropped after about a 2-3 yard gain. Bryce Bothwell, the defensive tackle, making the tackle.
There was a flag on the play for an illegal shift.
This will be the 12th penalty on Buford tonight.
And characteristic of this kind of team, you talk about, especially when you talk about pre-snap penalties for them, a lot of shifts. Right now, they're just in a run base heavy set. Yeah.
They burned three minutes off the clock already.
Three tight ends in the game.
I mean, this is right in their wheelhouse, right? Kill the clock.
Mill Creek.
So Mill Creek calls timeout. That leaves them with two. And time running out on the Hawks. 39-27, Buford leading. What a performance by Caleb Downs tonight. Looks like it might go in a losing effort.
Back pad all pulled down. Beware of the dog. Special teams. Just the mere fact that he was back on the kickoffs has forced Buford to have to pooch kick the ball.
Down 7 carries, 79 yards, 4 catches, 41 yards. Let's check in with John Nelson.
Fireflies are out here in the student section here at Tom Ryden as we are winding it down. Some other folks are in the barn tonight with final scores. Irwin County, a big region win tonight, 49-8 over Pelham. Lambert with a big win. They stay on the heavy side, on the left-hand side of the ledger. They're starting to get a lot of crooked numbers. They win 20-3. Bowden, single A, ranked near the top. They doubled Christian Heritage, 42-21. Carrollton, a winner. They knocked off the Brook, 42-12. Morgan County over Hepsiba, 49-33. And an emotional win tonight for the folks in Jefferson, shutting out Flowery Branch by the score of 27-0. A rainbow came out at Flowery Branch tonight. Big win for Jefferson there as well.
Yeah, our hearts, thoughts, prayers continue to be with that Jefferson community as they mourn the loss of Elijah DeWitt. Tough times for that community. Second down and 7, ball at the 47, keeper by Whitke. And he's going to get stopped on the other side of the 50. Etchison making the tackle, and now Mill Creek burns another timeout.
Nice job by Whitke making the read. What I like is he's aggressive when he attacks the line of scrimmage. He doesn't wait. He's big-bodied. He goes up in there. He knows he's going to take some hits.
It's the three-star quarterback. He's committed to Virginia Tech, committed to the Hokies, over 17 other offers, including East Carolina. Let's check in with Hannah Gooden, find out what's coming up in the postgame show.
Thanks, Matt. Coming up on that postgame show, presented by the Governor's Office of Highway Safety, we already have coaches waiting to call in to talk about their games. A couple more final scores for you. Brooks County handed Early County its first loss of the season, 34-7, the final in that one. And in Region 5-3A, Sandy Creek beat Carver Atlanta 22-12. We are filling out all of our sheets, all of our final scores, and coaches that we're going to be talking to. Stick around after the broadcast to hear what they have to say.
I'll be watching. Looking forward to that. Jam-packed, stellar post-game show. Get you up on all the scores. Hear from all the coaches. See Dylan Whitke committed to Virginia Tech. Three-star quarterback Devin Farrell, who was at Milton last year. He's up at Virginia Tech now. Be competing against each other. Third and 3. Time running out on Mill Creek. Timeouts running out for Mill Creek.
Huge third down here. Got to get the ball back. Another set of downs takes this clock down to a minute. Justice Haynes back in the game.
Toss goes to him, and he's got the first down. Still moving. Finally, Caleb Downs and Justice Haynes collide and down to the 40-yard line, and that might be it. Still got 4 minutes to go here, and anything can happen, but Mill Creek is just about running out of options.
Nice zone blocking by the line. One cut up the field, shoulder square, pushing the pile. I'm going to end this game for my team. I'm not going to give you the ball back. Nice job there by Justice Haynes.
19 carries for 211 yards.
What a big night. I played with his dad with the Steelers for a couple of years. Verron Haynes. I don't think Verron had that kind of speed, though. I have to go back and look. He has to be proud of his son.
Offense. First down.
That's what made Justice Haynes' commitment to Alabama so shocking for Georgia fans, because I think they just naturally assumed, since Verron starred with the Bulldogs, son Justice would follow suit. But Justice Haynes announced that he was making his own path, committing to Alabama during the summer. Number two running back in the class of 2023. Maddox rumbles down to the 36. And Mill Creek might have used their last timeout. They did. So at this point, you know, if they give up another first down, they may never get the ball back at this point. It's come down to that now, with a second and 11 coming up. But a game that did not disappoint on this October night.
Both teams came in with a lot of emotions. As you said, Matt, only 10, 12 miles apart. You imagine that rivalry. As you said, this is the first game they've played. This Mill Creek team has sat over there in their community and heard the word Buford, 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 and been waiting on a chance to get over here and play this Wolves team.
So the Wolves, barring a collapse here, will improve to 7-0 on the season. And five of those seven wins will have come against top 10 ranked teams. They beat the number two team in 7A from Alabama, Thompson, 38-7. They beat the number 10 team from 4A in North Carolina, Mallard Creek, 56-7. They beat North Cobb, who we've seen twice here on GPB. Beat them 21-14. North Cobb ranked seventh. Got another win tonight. Beat Wheeler. Heavy rush, and Whitkey throws it away. See if they drop a flag on that. And if that's backwards, then that's a fumble out of bounds.
Definitely was a backwards pass. Very dangerous. Very interesting that Buford in that situation decided to throw the ball any kind of reference to this game. You imagine they were going to just run the next two downs and take what they get.
Yeah, because now it's set up with that play going backwards so dramatically. Mill Creek's going to have a chance to get the ball back. Watch the ref. Yeah, rule that's a backwards pass.
Very dangerous there by the senior quarterback.
So in essence, it becomes a fumble. A backwards pass is a fumble out of bounds. And so now it's fourth down, and Buford's going to have to give it up. Wasn't able to totally run the clock out here. Hawks going to get the ball back. And probably with more time than I thought they would, by the time they kick it and get the ball, set it down, and run a play, it'll probably be about 210. Maybe 215. And Caleb Downs, you can look at that uniform and tell that's a man who's done a lot of work tonight. Yep. He has been a dog.
He has definitely been that tonight. What a dynamic athlete he has shown to be, living up to billing in every way that you have been, every way he's been described. He lived up to that tonight.
I mean, if you're an Alabama fan, how excited must you be after watching these two guys go at each other tonight? Caleb Downs has been spectacular on both sides of the ball. Justice Haynes has rushed for 216 yards.
And what you really love is that with all those stars and all those rankings and headed to Alabama, they're still engaged in the game. They're not out there looking yep. for an exit or just living off what they have done already. They shine tonight in this game.
Caleb Downs, Justice Haynes, number one prospect in the state. Caleb Downs, five-star going to Bama. Number two prospect in the state, Justice Haynes, five-star going to Bama.
What's the over and under they end up being roommates? Yeah. You know, after
what's
a game
the
like
over
this?
Under that they're in the NFL draft yeah. 4 years from now in 2026? Here's the punt. And going to hit and be downed inside the 20. They'll spot it at the 17. So that's where Mill Creek goes back to work. They got to score two touchdowns and somehow get the ball back after scoring the first one. And we've got 2:08 to go. Join us next Friday night. Got another spectacular 7A game for you as the Carrollton Trojans, their freshman quarterback, Juju Lewis. You're going to love watching this kid play. Goes up against the Westlake Lions and four-star Clemson commit Avion Terrell. That's next Friday night right here on GPB, right after recruiting 2022. Pass complete to Cam Robinson. Going to step out of bounds and stop the clock. And Buford ran 5 minutes and 21 seconds off the clock on that drive after Mill Creek had decided to punt it away on the fourth and four.
He gets something deep, looking for Caleb Downs down the field.
Clark is being chased, throwing on the run, squeezes it in a tight spot to Caleb Downs, who makes a great catch in traffic at the 33.
Buford secondary, keep everything in front of you. Make them earn each and every yard. Your clock is, they have no timeouts.
Saw the smile on Caleb Downs' face. He knows, not only from the community, but he knows from recruiting so many of these guys, because when they're out there making their visits, they're meeting all kinds of people from all over the place. Pass complete to Wood. Wood out of bounds at the 44-yard line.
Off in coverage, you have to come up and be sure in your tackling in this situation. Only rushing three right now. Mill Creek in this 2 minute situation doing just what you want to do. They keep keeping the ball out on the edge, making first downs or getting out of bounds.
First and 10, slide down by Clark. He'll have to get back to the line of scrimmage quickly because the clock is running.
Second down.
Lots of time burning here. Heavy rush. Clark. Wood, or pardon me, Downs with the catch and run. Clock's going to continue to run. He does not pick up the first down as he gets the ball to the 49. Looks like he's got a cramp, and that will stop the clock, but he will have to come off the field.
Well-deserved cramp. No one can question him playing possum. We have literally seen this young man play an entire game. You saw him earlier in the half where he was trying to get it massaged out.
So the question becomes, Wayne, will we see these two teams again in the state playoffs? 13 touches for 131, a couple of touchdowns for Downs tonight. He's also got, by my count, around 6 or 7 tackles. That's not official. But 7 carries for 79 yards, 6 receiving receptions for 52 yards. He comes off the field after the cramp. It's 3rd down and 4. Pass thrown incomplete. Now it's going to be 4th down. And the way the playoffs are set up, I don't think there's any way that a 1-2 team from the same region can meet until the state finals. And we've seen it happen before. Saw it last year in single-A with Brooks County and Irwin County. In fact, one year, I think we had like 2 or 3 teams from the same region playing in the state finals. Will it happen here in 7A? A lot of football to play before then. 4th and 4, last chance for Mill Creek going up top. And Wood cannot run under it. And ball will go over on downs to Buford. And that's going to do it for Mill Creek tonight on offense.
Great job of fighting and try to keep themselves in this game. Electrifying crowd for both of these teams. Atmosphere that very seldom you can create, and especially in the regular season in a high school game.
What a ball game. I hope you enjoyed it. That is one heck of a football Friday in Georgia right there between two great teams. Buford's going to run their winning streak to 18 games. Improved to 7-0. Be in the driver's seat to win the region championship for a 3rd consecutive year. And for the 32nd time in program history.
Great job of this team. A lot of pressure on them to continue, not just their own winning streak, but to come in this game and perform at a high level, living up to a national ranking, is beautiful.
Number 7 in the most recent USA Today Super 25. They've been as high as number 3 in the nation. This, no doubt, will give them some bounce in that poll. And you see Bryant Appling pump his fist as he runs onto the field in a 39-27 victory for the Buford Wolves, the number 1 team in the state, now 7-0 on the season.
Physical run game, flying around on defense. Mill Creek comes into this game averaging 46 points. Buford holds them to 27. And on the legs of Justice Haynes in the second half, especially, just a dominant performance running the ball.
Haynes goes for over 200 yards tonight. Just a hard-fought battle tonight between two great teams. And Buford, as they so often have done for over a year now, goes through the congratulatory line with the victory in their hands. So the Wolves improved to 2-0 in Region 8-7A. Tequila coming up next Friday night in their regular season home finale. Mill Creek drops to 6-1 overall, 1-1 in the region. And they will host Collins Hill next Friday night. Defending 7A champions in a little bit of a rebuild. We saw them earlier this year on GPB with a win over Brookwood.
And the thing about this game tonight too, Matt, we didn't hit on it a lot, but Buford has a lot to prove to themselves. A lot of people are still questioning whether they can play at this level. They're used to playing at a lower level with not as much depth, but this team, not
there
a real
are
weakness.
The future Alabama teammates. Boy, those guys played individually great ball games tonight, team-wise great ball games tonight. It's tough to take a loss, but Mill Creek's got nothing to be ashamed of tonight. Certainly Buford played another outstanding game, as we have come accustomed to with their standard that they have set in that program over the last 20 years. The best in the state. Valdosta's got more state championships in state history, but there's no doubt that here in 2022, Buford is the number one program in the state. So John Nelson's got it set up. We're getting ready to send it over to him with our Georgia Cotton Commission player of the game. Nelly?
Thank you, Matt. Let's catch up with Coach App first. One of the first things I noticed in the handshake line was that you gave Dickie May one of the biggest bear hugs I've ever seen. One of your mentors, especially when it comes to defense, and to be able to share that with him tonight, obviously big.
Yeah, it is big. It's big to share with Michael every day. But Dickie, I owe Dickie everything in my career, just about him and Jess, and obviously Dexter, but he taught me everything I know. I didn't know anything when I first got here. He came here my second year and just, he grew me up as a coach.
When you look at this game tonight, I mean, it was ebbs and flows and backs and forths, and then it just came down to a lot of want to there in the fourth quarter. Break down that fourth quarter for me, because it was close. Then there was a little bit of time where it kind of got some distance, then it got close all over again.
Yeah, I mean, it's 7A football, 7A playoff football. That's what it was. I'm glad my kids got a taste of it. Couple times this year we've already had, but being able to play a rivalry game like that and step up at the end of the game, I couldn't ask for much more, man. Just happy we got out here with a win. We set ourselves up for late on in the season, but we got a long way to go still. We made way too many pre-snap mistakes, way too many mistakes all around. So we got a long way to go. I think we played a dang good game tonight. I still don't think we played our best ball yet.
Coach App, thanks for your time.
Appreciate it.
Time to tag out. Justice, your turn. All right, so we got the hat. Let me fix the towel there for you. Let's work on the towel here a little bit. Make sure that the logo. No, it's all good. There we go. Make sure the logo, it matches the same direction. There we go. We'll figure it out. There we go. Justice Haynes, as we now tag in. What was it like out there tonight? Because obviously two top 20 teams nationally going after it, and I know that the relationship with you and Caleb is pretty tight. What was it like out there for you tonight?
You know, first and foremost, I got to give thanks to God. You know, without him, none of this is possible. And then I got to give thanks to my offensive line, my quarterback. You know, he played a great game. He had two touchdowns as well. The receivers, the blocking downfield, the tight ends, and the other fellow running backs. You know, we played an all complete round game. The defense played great. But going back to your question, with how was it playing, you know, Caleb and I are really good friends, but on this football field, you know, this week I was not friends with him at all. You know, I have so much respect for them and that team and him as a player, and they played a well-fought game, and we're just fortunate to come out on top.
All right, so let me let you brag on your offensive line here a little bit, because you had the long touchdown run where it looked like you found like fourth and fifth gear, you know, with about 30 yards to go. What's it like running behind those guys, knowing that the holes are going to be there, you hit them at full speed?
It's a lovely. I love this offensive line, you know. Going from my left tackle all the way to my right tackle, you know. They work their behinds off every practice. And, you know, they're always working. We have a really good relationship, and I love those boys. I'll do anything for those boys, and they do everything for me.
Where do you think Buford is as a football team right now? Obviously a big win in region. You're a 2-0. Obviously a lot of folks are looking at you nationally and all that kind of stuff, and you guys have to block that out. Where do you think you are right now as a team?
I think we took some steps this week, but you know, like Coach App will tell you too, we have not played our best football yet, and we still are just continuing to strive. We want to peak at the right time, so just continue to get better each week, you know, and just continue to keep. I think we took a forward direction this week in practice and in this game, but we got to continue to keep growing, you know, and we haven't even reached our potential.
22 carries, north of 200 on the night. Justice Haynes, because he's got the hat and he's got the towel, that means only one thing. He's the Georgia Cotton Commission player of the game, the Georgia Cotton Commission, the natural choice for Georgia. Justice, thanks for hanging out.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Big win for Buford tonight. Let's send it back to 260-14, because I believe we're getting that much closer to the postgame show, aren't we?
We are indeed. And a reminder once again, next Friday night, Football Friday in Georgia, coming to you from Atlanta. It's a big Region 2 7A battle. Carrollton Trojans taking on the Westlake Lions. Ton of talent on the field next Friday night. Looking forward to that right after recruiting 2022. So, Wayne, you kind of hit the nail on the head. Believe it or not, there's still some people wondering if Buford can play in 7A. Do you have any doubts?
I have no doubts right now. They showed no weakness that they won't be playing for another title here in a couple of weeks.
Well, they'll be playing for the region title, and in December, perhaps playing for a fourth consecutive state title. A convincing 39-27 victory tonight over number 3 and undefeated Mill Creek as the Wolves improve to 7-0 on the season. And Justice Haynes goes for over 200 yards as the 5-star Alabama commit, along with Caleb Downs, another 5-star Alabama commit, puts on a show. And now for Wayne Gandy and our entire GPB team, I'm Matt Stewart. So long from Buford. The post-game show with Hannah Gooden and John Nelson is absolutely next.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is presented by the Governor's Office of Highway Safety, reminding you to be safe on every trip. Buckle up, Georgia.